Good Saturday evening, Eagle fans, and welcome to JPS Field at Malone Stadium on the campus of the University of Louisiana Monroe. Side of tonight's Sun Belt matchup between the ULM Warhawks and your Georgia Southern Eagles. Hello, everybody. This is Chris Blair alongside Terry Harvin, Danny Reed on the sidelines, Russ Brown, our engineer Colin Lacey, and studio producer Drew Whaley on hand to bring you tonight's play-by-play story. Back in late November 2014, these two teams battled it out at Paulson Stadium, with the Eagles securing their undefeated conference championship 22-16, but it went down to the wire, as we all remember. This year is the second matchup in league play for the Eagles and the conference opener for the Warhawks. ULM comes in 1-2 with a blowout win over Nicholls State, two losses to two SEC powers that battled earlier today between the edges in Athens, Alabama, and Georgia. The Eagles seem to have put the week one nightmare in West Virginia behind them and have reeled off three straight wins in fine fashion, including last week's 44-20 conference win over Idaho. Tonight marks the sixth meeting all time between these two schools, with the Eagles holding serve 3-2. However, an interesting note, in the series, the home team has won all previous meetings, including Monroe's last win here at home in 1991 by a final score of 21-13. And Harvo, tough two-week stretch traveling for Coach Willie Fritz and company. Last week it was Idaho, this week Louisiana. The good news, if you can get a win here tonight, you get that week off to rest and re-energize for what will be another tough leg of the 2015 schedule.
A must-needed break for the Eagles. Injuries, we've had a few of them. We could definitely use the rest after being on the road. Like you said, long trip to Idaho, now out here to Louisiana. It's going to be good to get back home to the friendly confines of Allen E. Paulson Stadium, and where we have a real crowd that shows up and supports the Eagles. Now, today on the road, do see a great group of Eagles there. Saw them today, Chris, out and about in the town. We're definitely there in the corner of the end zone.
High above JPS Field here at Malone Stadium. Great area here in Monroe. Got the athletic complex really all sealed up here. We've got the football stadium. You've got the baseball stadium to our left, the softball field. And, of course, as the guys talked about in the countdown to tip-off, or kickoff, I should say, they have a great area for tailgating, and apparently maybe some fans still, Terry, waiting to come in for kickoff, which is really just moments away as the officials meet at midfield. We'll have the captains coming out in just a little bit. But as I mentioned, first conference game for ULM, and, you know, we talked about it all week, and, of course, you guys discussed it on the countdown to kickoff. Really hard to judge what this ULM team is all about. Certainly they are injured. The Eagles are banged up, which has been noted. But kind of hard to gauge how good this team is for the Warhawks based on the schedule through their three games so far.
You're right on the money there, because the Alabama game, Alabama did not look like their normal, or like they look today against Georgia, like they played last week. I know they shut them out, but it was, what, 14-0 at halftime. It wasn't anything to write home about. They held Alabama to 300 yards of offense, a team that traditionally is 550 yards of offense. So, yeah, ULM has their own injury bug to deal with. Their first ball game, again, it's homecoming for them, but there's a cloud over this program today. As they got word this morning, one of their own, a backup quarterback, passed away suddenly last night, and that has impacted the program, of course, and our thoughts and prayers are with their families, with the family of Daniel Fitzwater, who was a backup quarterback, Chris, and the Warhawk Nation.
Certainly a tough day, and as Terry mentioned, our thoughts and prayers go out to his family and those here at ULM. Very hard to understand a 20-year-old who is now gone. So it will be a little different for Coach Barry and company. I understand they canceled their normal walk through the crowd and kind of kept things on a low tone as they get ready to open up conference play against Georgia Southern. The Eagles on the far sideline, dressed in their home, or rather road white, white tops, white bottoms, Georgia Southern blue helmets. Different look, the B-45 for the homestanding Warhawks. They're in gray, red bands around their thighs, actually. And white helmets with the Warhawk logo on both sides. So we're set to go. Georgia Southern will kick it off to get things started here. They'll kick left to right. Again, as we mentioned, very windy down on the field, almost a tunnel here. Both end zones are wide open, although they have get set to begin construction on an operations center in the left corner to the near side. But right now, it is an absolute wind tunnel running down the field.
Nice facility.
Youngway Koo will kick this off for the Eagles. First half kickoff presented by Georgia Farm Bureau and your Georgia Farm Bureau agents since 1959, serving the interest and insurance needs of Georgia residents and Georgia residents only. Young Wei Koo, boot meets ball, and we're underway. Here in Monroe puts this one well out of the back of the end zone, a touchback. And that will set up first down 10 at the 25-yard line for Garrett Smith, the redshirt freshman quarterback, replacing Pete Thomas, who really did a phenomenal job last year. In fact, set quite a number of records here at ULM. Smith, 6 feet, 211-pounder. 66 for 99 on the season, 650 yards passing. He's got five touchdowns to three interceptions. Not a big threat to run. He's got 32 carries, 71 yards, and one rushing touchdown.
This is a team that likes to air the ball out quite a bit. There's something from the officials on the sideline, illegal formation against Georgia Southern. And the penalty is going to be added, so it's going to put the ball at the 30-yard line for the Warhawks. Young Wei Koo kicked it out of the end zone about 4 yards deep beyond the back line. As I mentioned early on, the wind is a factor. It's crossing from left to right from the Georgia Southern sideline to the home. And first penalty of the day goes against Georgia Southern.
So the Warhawks come out on offense. First down. Again, after the infraction, they'll start things at the 30-yard line. Right out of the gate, they'll keep it on the ground, carrying the football. Kalen Watson, the sophomore running back out of Mahia, Texas, trying to come near side. Pretty good coverage out there on the corner by the Eagles. Makes it to the 32-yard line. Pickup of two. It'll be second down and eight for the Warhawks here early on the opening drive of the first quarter.
Great closing by Ironhead. Came out of nowhere to seal the gap and make the tackle.
They'll stack trip receivers to the far side, one right after another. Here's the snap. Throw. Set up the screen. This is what they want to do. Catch is made. One tackle broken and up across the 35 to the 36. As a Jalen Holly, really the best receiver on the field this evening for the Warhawks, a junior out of Hot Springs, Arkansas. Sets it up third down and five here for ULM.
ULM coming into the ball game. Chris averaging about 38% on third down.
Third down and a little less than five. Smith now will send his offensive back in the slot. It'll be an empty set here on third and four. Set up the screen. Catch made at the 35, getting to the 40, but stopped there. Marcus Green hauls in the catch, and the Eagles bring him down quickly. Looks like he may have enough with forward progress to pick up that first down, but maybe just shy. The nose of the football, they're going to place inside the 40.
Wow.
So it'll be fourth and less than a yard here for the Warhawks.
Again, Ironhead came in with a great tackle there, was able to keep his momentum from going any further, but he was able to pick up the first down and move the chains. The ball's going to be spotted at the 40-yard line.
So again, ball just inside the 40, but they take a look at it, say it's a first down, so the drive stays alive. First down and 10 at the 40-yard line of their own as they attack right to left. Here's the handoff. Kalen Watson coming around the right side. Eagles find him quickly and drop him after he makes it across the 42. That's about all she wrote. Bernard Dawson, Antoine Williams combining on the tackle for the Eagles.
Zone read on the right-hand side. And Chris De La Rosa is in the ballgame playing, by the way, at linebacker, which is a good thing. But again, Antonio Glover came up hard and made the good tackle.
They give him 3 yards. It'll be second down and seven. Ball just shy of the 43-yard line of their own. Working from the far side hash. They'll motion the tight end across the formation right to left. Again, they'll keep it on the ground. Handoff going to Watson. Hit immediately and moving forward. Gets to about the 44-yard line, maybe a gain of a yard. It'll be third down and six upcoming. Antoine Williams there. There's a flag down at the play, late in the play. We'll see what it's all about, and we'll introduce you to our officials coming up in just a moment.
Antoine Williams walking up to the line of scrimmage from that outside linebacker position, made the initial hit. Stopped him long enough for a group of white jerseys to jump on top.
After the play was over, unsportsmanlike conduct on each team. Number 50, offense. Number 90, defense. This is the first unsportsmanlike conduct foul on each team player. The penalty's offset. Third down.
As you can hear from the wind noise, Chris, from that official, that tells you the atmosphere down there.
Awfully windy here on this Saturday afternoon, so the penalty's offset. Remains third down and about five here. ULM already connecting on a third down conversion in this opening drive. 12:36 clock moving, no score. Smith in the shotgun. Again, empty set. The motion, the running back at the snap. Smith, quick fire, and this one's going to be caught. They'll say no, incomplete, short hop at about the 47 to Demarius Gillespie. Just throwing a little low. That'll set up fourth down and five. And ULM, the drive will stall after starting at their own 30 after an infraction on the touchback. They'll have to punt it away. Chris Qualls will come in, the freshman punter out of Searcy, Arkansas, only averaging about 34 yards a kick. Back deep, Keegan Williams will await to field it at the 20-yard line of his own. Low snap, bobbled. He'll pick it up, and Qualls has it blocked out at the 30-yard line. Picked up and headed to the grass. Headed down the field. It's going to be Deshante Gallup with the block. Ken Butler Jr. scoop and score, and the Eagles take the early lead. 6-0 on special teams. Last week in Idaho, they got the block on the punt to open up that game. And Deshante Gallen, for the second straight week, gets his hands on it after a low snap, short hop, and Qualls trying to rugby-style kick it away. And Gallen heading dead to rights. Pick up by Butler, and he goes in for the score. And with 12:16 to play, the Eagles on special teams takes the early lead.
I thought special teams would have an issue with the wind, but I meant from a kicking standpoint to receiving. Wind wasn't a factor there, that's for sure.
Alex Hanks on for the point after. Matt Dobson to hold. Snap, set, kick on its way, and the kick is good. So the Eagles, special forces, getting it done early. 7-0, Georgia Southern's defense with the score. We'll return to Monroe, Louisiana in just a moment. You're listening to Georgia Southern football here on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports. Nothing. Georgia Southern on special teams blocks the punt of Chris Qualls. Ken Butler picks it up after Gallen got his hand on the football. And Butler rambles in for the score. 7-0. The Eagles now reach the end market end zone. Fans, your chance to receive a special offer from Endmarket. Just text the word Eagles to 90561. Endmark, friendly faces, fresh choices. And Terry, one of the things Coach Willie Fritz cut his teeth on very early as an assistant coach was special teams. And he certainly has put a focus on that since arriving in Statesboro on another job. Just like last week, got the early block punt against Idaho. This time, Butler, right place, able to land right in his hands. Nobody could haul him down before he made it to the end zone.
A low snap by the snapper to ULM. The punter not able to handle it very well. Finally gets a hold of it, tries to run to the right and kick it on the run. Ironhead in there quickly, blocks it almost for a scoop and score, but was able to block it where into one of our guys, and he carries it in for a touchdown. And the Eagles up early over this crowd for homecoming that is still yet to show up. But the good thing is it's going to silence them quickly, the ones that did. But Eagle Nation in the corner there, very loud, as Young Wei Koo tees it up and gets ready to kick off. The Domino's Drive Delivery, presented by Domino's, the world's leader in pizza delivery. It's raining back on the East Coast. Perfect time to call Domino's and have them deliver pizza so you can stay at home and listen to the ball game and enjoy your Eagle football.
Young Wei Koo back at it to kick it back to Monroe. Craig Caldwell back deep, but he won't get a chance at this one again out of the back of the end zone. And a touchback will set up ULM, first down and 10 at their own 25. Today's officiating crew presented by Dr. Horace Deal and Vision Source. When making the right call, your vision cannot be compromised. So schedule an appointment today with Dr. Horace Deal. Visit him online at drdeal.net, the official team eye doctor of the Georgia Southern Eagles. Out of the Sun Belt Conference, our crew chief and referee Jeff Hillier, umpire Kenneth Huffhines, head linesman Greg LaFille Sr., line judge Terry Algier, back judge Bill Sora, field judge Tom McCarter, side judge Chip Shields, and our replay official David Allman. First down and 10, Smith, play action, rolling to his right, a lot of pressure, now comes back to his left, trying to run for his life, going to be brought down at the 20-yard line. Ryan George tracks him down. That time the Eagles had them dead to rights again, almost as if they're in the huddle. They wanted to roll to the right, look downfield. Nothing but white jerseys in front of Garrett Smith, trying to improvise. Comes back to his left, and Ryan George again showing the speed. 6'1", 245 pounds, but the sophomore can move.
Bernard Dawson, he ran right into Bernard, turned around and ran the other way.
Again, Smith going to try to run. This time brought down behind the line again at the 18-yard line. Coming to the near side, Antoine Williams tracks him down. And now ULM just moving backwards here after getting the touchback. They're looking at third and long right out of the gate. Third and 15. Upcoming. Ball inside their own 20-yard line.
I tell you, the noticeable difference I've seen so far early in this game is the speed from our defense.
Trip receivers to the right, wide side of the field. Two receivers, empty set here for Smith. Eagles three down linemen. Deshante Gallen in the neighborhood. He'll back up for pass. Smith throws. This one overthrown and incomplete at the 35-yard line. And they'll say intercepted. Antonio Glover came from the backside. The pass was overthrown. Pat Thompson came across and made sure no receiver was there. And Antonio Glover able to pull down the interception, his fourth of the season.
Wow.
And the Eagles with great field position on the turnover, looking at the football at the 43-yard line of ULM after the turnover.
You watch this replay. Matt Dobson, very clean hit, takes it to the receiver's body. He went up for the ball, and right as it was getting to his hand, Matt Dobson took him and planted him in this brand-new, beautiful turf.
So now the Eagle offense on the field for the first time tonight. First down and 10 at the 43 of ULM, already up 7-0. Ellison gives to Breida, looking for the hole, and Breida right side inside the 40 and dives down near the 38-yard line of ULM. It was Trey Hunter eventually getting Breida down.
Real quickly, Chris, on the defense, we've been coming in with that true passing attack offense that they have with a three-man front.
They'll have three down linemen. They'll put their hawk up in a five technique, so really four defensive linemen here for ULM, similar to the way they played last year after the four-yard gain, second down and six. Ellison takes the snap, counter option. He's in trouble, ULM all over him, trying to stretch the field far side. Flag comes out, Ellison brought out of bounds. Back at the 44-yard line, a loss of a yard. Cody Robinson and Justin Backus giving chase. But a flag on the play very shortly after the snap. We'll see what it's all about.
Great penetration by the linebacker. Remember we talked about West Virginia and what they did. They were very similar. Cody Robinson came in quickly, read the play, was in the backfield, caused Ellison to go out of his normal routine there, I should say, where he was trying to run, and he had nowhere to go. Flag comes in late, probably would be a holding or maybe even a cut block.
Jeff Hillier will let us hear about it here momentarily.
Holding 56 offense. At least 10 yards. Repeat second down.
Roscoe Byrd, the guilty party for the Eagles. 6'3", 319-pounder. And this will back up Georgia Southern, their first penalty of the game, their first offensive drive of the game. They already lead 7-0. A block punt, scoop and score. And then an interception by Antonio Glover, and that's all ULM's been able to muster thus far. So the Eagles now look at a long second down situation, second and 16. Ball at the 49-yard line of ULM. Ellison with Breida just behind him out of that pistol set. Now they'll motion. Receiver left to right. Give to Breida. Breida right up the gut. Near side hash. Spins his way down to about the 42-yard line. Mitch Lane making the tackle from that hawk position. Defensively, a 3-3-5 for ULM. But last year, decided to really come at him with four defensive linemen. And the Eagles now looking at third and nine after a 7-yard gain. Ball at the 42-yard line. Two receivers left, two to the right. Ellison looking to throw. Blitz coming. He'll fire this one far side. Jump ball. Deflected and incomplete. Down around the 10-yard line. We're looking for Derek Keaton down the far side. Lindsey Pipkins was on coverage. Pretty good coverage for Pipkins. And that'll set up a very difficult. There's a flag down back at the 38-yard line far side in front of the Eagles sideline. We'll see what it's all about. Jeff Hillier.
Offside defense, number 76.
That's big.
55 yards.
Now, you see, that's a big penalty. It's going to give us a better shot of repeating third down here. That's good. Third down and four. The wind played a factor in that pass, Chris. As he threw that, you saw the receiver having to come back because the wind held the ball up in the air.
Johnson up front offsides. Gives the Eagles new life. Third down and a manageable four here from the 37-yard line. Give to Breida, trying to get those 4 yards down near the first down stick. Stopped just shy of the 32-yard line. Needed the 33. It looks like a Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles, and it is. Trey Hunter coming up to make the tackle on Breida. Second time those two have gotten together here. 9-10 remaining first quarter, 7-0 Georgia Southern with a special team score on a block punt.
The interception here to set up the Eagles a pretty good field position as L.A. Ramsby checks into the ballgame.
So Ramsby will have time in the offensive backfield for the first time tonight. James Dean in as the H-back. Ellison takes the snap, moves to his left, now wants to throw this one in triple coverage and incomplete. Miles Campbell can't hold on. But Ellison put it right between the defenders. Good throw by Ellison, and Campbell had a shot at it. Couldn't haul it in. Bring up second down and 10 with 8:46. The clock stopped here in the first quarter of action. Pipkins and Caldwell on coverage had him sandwiched going down the middle of the field.
He had two shots at it. Good throw and a good thing to stretch out the defense.
Wesley Fields checks in along with Matt Breida in that offensive backfield. Second down 10 at the 31-yard line. It's the pistol eye as Ellison play action. Comes out throwing again. This time overthrown. Longoria down at the 15-yard line near side. Had a chance to make the catch, but that one rode a little high off the fingertips of Ellison. And now sits down third down at 10, now at the 31-yard line.
Fields and Breida goes out. L.A. Ramsby comes in along with Campbell. Third down and 10. Ball's going to be on about 31.5-yard line.
Near side hash, third down and 10. Eagles on the season, 43% on third down. Great opportunity after the turnover here, trying to keep the drive alive. Ellison calls for the pistol snap. Warhawks look like they're coming after him, and they do. Ellison in trouble, brought down from behind at the 39-yard line.
Ellison is sacked by number 34, Michael Johnson.
Looks like another flag down. And it could be offsides. They may have jumped a little too soon trying to get to Ellison. We'll wait and see. Michael Johnson.
Yep.
He made the tackle.
That's why.
And had an extra jump start. So another penalty for ULM will keep the drive alive. What was third down and 10 will now be third down and 5. We're under 8.5 minutes to play, or rather 8:34. Clock stopped here in the first quarter.
He walked up on a blitz on the side there. It jumped very quickly as Breida comes into the ball game. Again, third and 5. Another crucial penalty for ULM to help Georgia Southern out.
The Eagles line up trying to convert on third down. Ellison has Breida on a wing to his left. Here's the snap out of the pistol. Comes firing. Catch made by Longoria at the 20. Gets away from a defender inside the 15. Out of bounds near side at the 13-yard line. Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles. Trey Hunter had to force him wide. Coach Doug Roos, the offensive coordinator right now, dialing up the passing plays. And the Eagles really loosening up what was an effective run defense a year ago. Seems to be the same type of play for ULM here in this game. Again, jumping at the front. Here's the pass. Throwing and overthrown. Left corner of the end zone. They were looking for Monte Crockett. Very close again. Looks like a flag is down. ULM trying to jump the count. They may have gotten the neutral zone.
Might be a pass interference against them is what I was expecting. He was wide open back there. Nope.
Offside defense.
Good.
5 yard penalty to be first down.
So the first down and 5 is going to put it inside the 10-yard line, which is good. He was wide open, Chris. Wide open.
Yeah, just overthrown by Ellison in the left corner of the end zone. But ULM self-destructing with penalties here. That's their fourth of the game. And their third offside penalty. Now it sets up first down and 5. Ball at the 8-yard line of ULM. Ellison goes left, now cuts back right. Looks to want to throw, but now will just tuck and take a hard hit. Loses the football at the 6, but able to grab it. And there's flags all over the field here on the near side.
There is a flag on the play.
That one may go against Georgia Southern. Based on the body language of one of our offensive linemen down there, Ellison took a hard hit on the ground after he fumbled it. He recovered it, and they came in hard off afterwards. I thought we might get a flag on that one since he was already on it. But
illegal block, but on the way. 15-yard penalty. It's
Illegal block below the waist. What happened is Ellison rolls out to the left. Great penetration by the Warhawk defense, causing them to come back around one of our offensive linemen. We went under and took it on his legs there. Check that, Derek Keaton, our wide receiver, did.
So that'll back the Eagles up. Still can pick up a first down. Down around the 3-yard line of ULM. Still a 7-0 game, and it seems like Georgia Southern has had the football most of this first quarter after two quick possessions by ULM. Here's the snap. Ellison looking left, has plenty of time. Now will be flushed out, goes right, cuts back left, has some daylight. There's a flag out as Ellison makes his way inside the 20 and dropped at the 18-yard line. That may be in the hold vicinity there against the Eagles. And boy, oh boy, the referees going to throw out their shoulders here in the first quarter.
Well, I mean, when you have a quarterback is scrambling back out there a good bit like that, you're going to have some of those calls go, be there. They're getting good.
Holding 63 offense, 10-yard penalty, first down.
The senior Darian Foreman guilty of the hold.
Let's talk about a cab ride. Isn't that one of your favorite scenes?
It's going to be one here.
Can't even keep up with how many plays and penalties we have going on right now. Max is up to the 32-yard line.
Now it's first down and 29 here for the Eagles.
First and 29, ball at the 32. Try that one out.
So first down, 29. Back at the 32-yard line, still on ULM's side of the field. 7-0 our score. Ellison calling for the snap. He's got Matt Breed in the backfield. Here's the give to Matt. Coming near side, 30, 25. Able to get to the 20-yard line before running into the boundary near side.
Good blocking by our receiver Longoria out there.
Trey Caldwell in on the tackle.
Pushing him out of bounds for the Warhawks.
Yeah, with Breida out there, brings up a second manageable.
Second and 20.
So a 12-yard gain by Matt Breida. And again, just second down, as Terry mentioned. Looked like the Eagles got inside the 15 and then backpedaled on penalties. Now looking at second and 17. Ball at the 20-yard line of ULM. This game has all been played on the Eagles, or rather ULM side of the field so far. Ellison calling for the snap. Play action again to Wesley Fields. Now Ellison in trouble, backpedaling, and throws this one near side, incomplete at the 20-yard line.
I like what Ellison did there, though. He didn't have a receiver open. Wesley Fields in the backfield. Flanker's out. He's got coverage. Instead of taking the sack or making a poor throw, he throws it at Wesley Fields' feet to get rid of the ball. Brings up third down for the Eagles.
So now a very important third down and 17. Eagles 2-for-2 so far in this early first quarter action. But a big one here in ULM. You can almost sense knows it's a passing down. And again, they'll line up. Four down linemen, linebackers showing they're coming. Now they'll drop back, pass protection. Here's the draw by Ellison. Has to move from left to right. Flag comes out as he makes his way to the 15. The 14 ball came out. Eagles dive on it. Think Ryan Longoria secured the ball, but another flag down. This one back at the 22-yard line.
They called it. They said that it was down on the ground, though, but there is a flag. Typically, again, that's in the holding zone. And we have a player down. Took a hard hit. He took a hard hit on the ground when he went down.
60 offense, 10-yard penalty.
Yeah, Kevin Ellison.
Yeah, he took a hard hit, Chris, on the ground.
After trying to cover up the football and losing it, everyone came rushing in. And as Terry mentioned, took a hard hit down there. Certainly hope he's all right as the training crew comes out to take a look. Clock stops, 6:07 remaining first quarter, 7-0. Georgia Southern with the lead after a block punt, scoop and score by Ken Butler. And Danny Reed down there on the sidelines. I mentioned it seems like Georgia Southern's been in this situation for so long. Both teams just going forward, then moving back. It almost seems like the ball's not moving at all down on the side of ULM.
Well, fortunately, for the most part, the ball is staying on ULM's side of the field. The punt block was huge, but Georgia Southern, they're taking one step forward, but it seems like it's about three or four more steps back. Now you're looking at, well, third down and forever, but just hopefully Kevin Ellison's all right.
So again, training crew taking a look at Ellison down around the 13-yard line to the near side, and we've got a timeout on the field. 6:07 remaining first quarter. Eagles lead 7-0. We'll return to Monroe, Louisiana in just a moment. You're listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports. Braswell's uniting America with over 400 award-winning products like red pepper jelly, sweet balsamic onion jam, and smoky chipotle mustard. Braswell's has plenty of options to make your tailgate a success, your breakfast, your lunch, your dinner a success. Look for Braswell's products in grocery stores and specialty shops across the nation or online at braswells.com. During the break, Kevin Ellison eventually hopping up and on his own power, able to run his way to the far sideline, which is a good sign there. Of course, we'll update you on that with Danny Reed coming up in just a little bit as the trainers still try to check on Kevin. But Fabian Upshaw will have to check in here. Eagles looking at third down and 27 at the ULM 30-yard line. ULM has not been stellar defensively, but penalties and more specifically holding calls have really backed the Eagles up after picking up the interception. Here's the handoff. Fields coming near side, breaks a tackle at the 20, steps away from a defender at the 15, and out of bounds near side at the 12-yard line. Great run for the freshman, Wesley Fields. It's kind of pick your poison if you're ULM defensively. You've got Matt Breida, who can break it at any given moment. L.A. Ramsby will certainly let you know he can come after you. And Wesley Fields picks up a great run there. Not enough for the first down. It sets up fourth down and 9. And Alex Hankson to try to add 3 points here. This will come from just inside the 20-yard line. So about a 29-yard field goal try. Hash mark near side. Dobson to hold. Here's the snap. Put down, kick on its way, and the kick is good. So Alex Hank stays perfect with the foot, and they extend the lead 10-0 with 5:22 remaining here in the first quarter. We'll return to Monroe, Louisiana in just a moment. Our score, Georgia Southern 10, ULM nothing. This is Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports.
2 left in the first quarter here. Georgia Southern leading ULM 10-0. Let's get you up to date on the Sun Belt scoreboard, brought to you by Spring Hill Suites. Idaho and Arkansas State knotted up at 7 apiece with 4 minutes to play in the first quarter. South Alabama out to a 7-0 lead over Troy, 6:47 to play in that one. Just down the road a little ways, Louisiana Lafayette is knotted up with Louisiana Tech, 7-7 as they play with 4 minutes to go in the first quarter. Two finals to tell you about. Appalachian State knocked off Wyoming, 31-13, and the Liberty Flames knock off Georgia State, 41-33. Chris?
Thank you, Russ. 5:22 remaining here in the first quarter. 10-0 our score. Real quickly, go down to Danny Reed. Kevin Ellison knocked out of that last series, but good news is, Danny, he probably will be back. What's the latest?
Yeah, they just looked at him real quickly. It looks like a stinger. There was some slight numbness in the right wrist, right arm area. Brandy Klaus said as soon as he gets the strength back, he'll be back in the game.
Optum Orthopedics Eagle Injury Update presented by Optum Orthopedics. They get you back to you, the official sports medicine provider to Eagle Athletics. So Youngway Kuan to kick it back. Once again, we'll talk about that run by Wesley Fields. Looking at third down and forever, and the big run by Wesley allows Alex Hanks to put it through the upright. Pivotal moment early on in this game. Youngway Ku puts a foot in this one, end over end. 9 yards deep. They'll take it and have to take a knee.
There's a shock.
Another flag down this time on the side of the Eagles, far side at the 40. Already won on special teams on the opening kickoff. We'll see what this one's about.
Obviously not doing something right on the kickoff that the officials...
At the kick, number 81 was offside. 5-yard penalty will be added to the touchback. First down.
Second time that's happened on the kickoff team. ULM's going to get the ball on their 30-yard line. That last drive from the Eagles set up from a great interception by Glover after a great hit by Dobson. 11 plays, 31 yards. 5 or 6 penalties. 5 minutes and 37 seconds.
Sixth penalty of the night so far for Georgia Southern. And Garrett Smith will keep come around the left side and be met by a wall of Eagles led by DeShante Gallen. Along with Antoine Williams and Antonio Glover. Not a lot of room there.
Tackled by number 16.
Yeah, which one are you going to pick?
Glover and
two linebackers and a safety, Chris.
Picked up 4 yards. It'll be second down. And a short 7 here. They'll say 7 yards, more like 6 for Garrett Smith and company. He'll have a single back and a wing to his left side. Now they'll roll him out into the slot right side. Smith with an empty set. Looking left, fires, catch made across the 36 and up to the 40-yard line. Great catch by Jalen Holly. He'll be the favorite target for Smith tonight. He'll pick up the ULM first down up to the 41-yard line.
Nice pet. Nice pitch and catch. Felt right where he needed to get it. Receiver ran a great route.
Coach Willie Fritz and company, Coach Jack Curtis, expecting a lot of empty sets here for ULM. First down and 10, just shy of their own 41-yard line, attacking right to left again on the near side hash. Smith, single back set, looking left, pump fakes, now fires, and this one caught and bobbled and dropped at the 47-yard line of Georgia Southern. Almost an interception. Jared Mapps had it in his hands, but couldn't hold on, and Matt Dobson made sure with a ricocheting hit. And the ball was up for grabs. Nobody can hold on. It's incomplete. It sets up second down 10 at the 41.
Caleb Williams on coverage. This particular case of which Dobson was focusing on the ball, might have had an INT, but he really took a hit on it.
Trip receivers to the right, wide side of the field. Smith, handoff. A lot of room. This time Watson up across the 45 and tripped up just shy of midfield by Matt Dobson coming up to make the tackle. But a nice-looking move in the offensive line, clearing everyone out to the weak side on the left, allowing Watson to pick up 9 yards. It'll be third and one at the 49-yard line. Quick snap. They'll put it in the belly of Watson again. He'll carry a couple of Eagles to Georgia Southern territory to about the 48-yard line and pick up the first down for ULM.
Great play call earlier on that drive, on that draw. They got an offensive lineman down quickly, or they're coming out. ULM off to a very, very slow start here tonight. Opening punt is blocked for a touchdown. Next series, they get INT. Eagles up early, 10 to nothing. As shade has taken over Malone Stadium here on the field. It's a little cool, very windy.
So for the first time this evening, ULM on the Eagles side of the field. Looking at first down and 10 at the Georgia Southern 48-yard line as they help Chase Regian off. The offensive lineman slow to get up on his own power. Coming into the game will be Jake Snyder, the redshirt freshman out of Wynn, Arkansas. Moves up front for ULM. First down and 10 at the 48. Smith with a single back and a wing to his right side. Trip receivers to the right. Little play action. Smith now will fire across the middle. Catch is made at the 40 and up down to the 45 or 35 is Harley Ciano, a tight end. 6'5 graduate student out of Reserve, Louisiana, picks up the first down for ULM. And for the first time, the Warhawks now on the charge, wasting no time. They line up quickly. Play action. Smith again under duress. Going to be brought down.
Thank goodness.
At the 38-yard line, Jay Ellison able to come in, make the sack, his first of the season, along with help from Ryan George. And they were right there when Smith took the snap.
And thank goodness they were, because that he had one more second. They had a receiver right up the gut, standing in the end zone wide open, uncovered. Because of that quick offense, we didn't get a man on him.
So now, after the play, second down and 14 is Smith. Empty backfield, sets up the screen. And brought down quickly, Marcus Green. He was able to haul in the catch, and Georgia Southern collapses quickly. Drops him at the 36-yard line. That'll set up third down and 12 upcoming here for ULM.
Good pickup by Antoine Williams. Sniffed out the screen, stayed with him, made the tackle.
Just above the near side hash, two receivers to the right, two to the left side. Single back here for Garrett Smith. Third down and 12. Motion Hawkins, the tight end. Now trip receivers and now movement up front. Georgia Southern says they were drawn offsides.
Three flags came out.
Eagles already 6 penalties, ULM with 3.
9 penalties on the day so far. Can't say they're very indisputable either. Yeah.
Frank Sutton Jr. and Ryan George, good sportsmanship down there, shaking each other's hand. They know it hasn't been clean up front.
Going against the Eagles.
Looks like they...
On the snap, defense was in the neutral zone, causing an offensive player to react. That's offside defense, 5-yard penalty, third down.
Hard to believe, 7th penalty so far. Still 2:20 remaining in the first quarter, and very uncharacteristic. Georgia Southern and Coach Willie Fritz talks about Eagles not beating the Eagles, and that's pre- and post-snap penalties, and they've had a share of them here so far in the first quarter. It sets up ULM now a little more manageable, 3rd down and 7 from the 31-yard line of Georgia Southern. Smith will switch the running back Devontae McNeil to the far side. Now put him in the slot far side, and movement again. Looked like it was Chase Regan on the right side of that offensive line, came up ready to block. We'll see who this goes against.
But again, if we caused him to do that and jumped in the neutral zone and took off too quick, so that one might be going against them.
False start, 71 offense, 5-yard penalty, third down.
Chase Regan picks up the fourth penalty for ULM tonight.
Goodness gracious.
That'll be 11 penalties so far on both teams. And we just got under the two-minute mark here in the first quarter. 10-0 Georgia Southern with a lead. ULM with their best field position of the night, looking at third down and 12 now. From the Eagle 36-yard line. Snap to Smith. Looking to his left. Now fires across the middle. Incomplete. Hit him in the hands, but he can't hold on at the 20-yard line. Jalen Holley. Pretty good throw by Smith. That time probably needed to be hauled in by his receiver. Did not do his QB any favors, and that will set up fourth down and 12 at the Eagle 36. And decision time here for Coach Todd Berry.
They'll go forward here. The Portis, when they jumped offside, really took them out of field goal range. At least they were getting close to it. They're going to go forward here. Fourth and 12. The ball spotted the 36. They had an open receiver. They just couldn't hang on to the ball.
ULM 40% on fourth down so far this year through three games. Fourth down and 12 at the 36. Empty backfield for Smith. Trip receivers right, looking right all the way. Fires, batted down at the line and incomplete at the 34-yard line. DeJounte Gallen got his hands on it. He's been busy today, blocking punts and knocking down passes. And a turnover on downs will give it to Georgia Southern. After a 10-play drive for ULM, finally got into Eagle territory, but the Eagles able to turn it the other way, but there's a flag down at the 40-yard line, so hold the phone. We'll see what it's all about. Looked to be a late flag
after
on that.
After the play was over, unsportsmanlike conduct, number 71, Louisiana Monroe.
Good.
Number 71's first unsportsmanlike 15-yard penalty. First down.
Something tells me Todd Berry's going to have a talk with Chase Regan. That's his second penalty in that drive. And that one going to be a little more costly because turnover on downs. And after the infraction, puts the ball now at the ULM 49-yard line. And the Eagles have played on the Warhawks side of the field all night, albeit credit ULM. Kept the Eagles out of the end zone last time. And really a tug of war on that last possession by Georgia Southern, hampered by five penalties alone.
Well, they did a good job defensively at times, but I think the last series, Georgia Southern kept Georgia Southern out of the end zone with the penalties and the poor decision-making. And that one, it's good to report, though, Kevin Ellison is back into the ballgame with Matt Breeder stacked right behind him.
Two receivers to his left, two to the right side, first down and 10 from the 49 of ULM. Give to Breeder, bounces to the near side, got room. Runs out of room at the 40. They try to strip the football to no avail. But a nice pickup of 9 yards by Matt Breida. Sets up second down and one here for the Eagle offense as Breida comes in on the season, coming into the game. 53 carries, 589 yards, 8 rushing touchdowns. Has a long of 87 on the season. In fact, 2 from 80 yards or more so far in 2015. It'll be second down and one. Ball placed at the ULM 40-yard line. Two receivers, Monte Crockett out wide to the left. Keegan Williams just off the line to the right side. Now, though, motion, Kevin Ellison, direct snap, L.A. Ramsby, and he'll take it on the Wild Eagle, get inside the 40, just shy of the 38-yard line before Hunter Kissinger, the middle linebacker, able to make the tackle for ULM. We've seen that formation quite a bit. You always have to be concerned. Ramsby, the former quarterback out of Cincinnati, certainly knows how to throw a football, and you put Kevin Ellison out there, and defense has to think for just a few moments, and L.A. Rams will be picking up.
They're still going to measure it. I think they're going to measure it.
Yeah, it looks like they'll bring the chains. Looked like he had it.
Yeah.
But they're going to say his knee was down right around the 39-yard line. I thought he had lunged forward to the 38, but they'll bring the chains out to make a look. Looks like the ball is placed right on the 39-yard line. Straddling is the football here, so they'll stretch the chains out. And by the nose, it's a Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles.
Previous play, I want to give credit where credit's due. Andre Sims, wide receiver, not getting a lot of playing time. Senior out of Snellville came in and threw a big block for Breeder to get to the corner and get us in that second one scenario so that L.A. could push it in. L.A.'s going to stay in the game along with James Dean.
First down and 10, now at the ULM 39-yard line. Lone touchdown coming up on special teams in the opening drive for ULM. a block punt. Here's the give to Ramsby. Finds the A-gap right side and then falls forward inside the 35 down near the 33-yard line before Trey Hunter comes up to make the tackle for ULM, but a good pickup on first down by L.A. Ramsby. 7 yards. It'll be second down and three. Eagles trying to be a little cleaner offensively with this possession on the ULM side of the field. As we mentioned, much documented, self-destructing last time. They had great field position. In fact, got inside the 15-yard line inside the clubhouse red zone before having to settle for the field goal. Ellison takes the snap. Second down and three. Give off to this time Ramsby. He's hit immediately. Great tackle by Hunter Kissinger with help from Lorenzo Jackson. And they bring Ramsby down quickly. About the line of scrimmage, no real gain on that play. It'll be third down, maybe lost a yard. It'll be third and four for Georgia Southern. With a timeout, nope, the end of the first quarter. So after one quarter of play, 10-0 our score. Georgia Southern leads over ULM. Second quarter action upcoming. We'll return to Monroe in just a moment. You're listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports. Fans Bullet Telephone, your local provider for voice, video, and data services, serving all customers with fiber optic facilities and over 2,500 miles of fiber cable. Bullet Telephone, the home of the latest telecommunication technology. Bullet Telephone, serving Bullet County since 1951. We start the second quarter here on a beautiful night in Monroe, Louisiana. Clear skies, still a little cool, wind very brisk here in Monroe. At the end of one quarter, your Vaden-Nissan stat line. Georgia Southern, 10 carries, 59 yards on the ground. 9 carries, 12 yards for the Warhawks. Through the air, Georgia Southern, 1 of 4. ULM, 5 of 10. There is that one interception. Antonio Glover with his fourth of the season. Passing yards, Georgia Southern right now, 13. ULM, 30. It's a 10-0 Georgia Southern lead. A block punt in the opening drive. Shante Gallen with his second block punt of the season. And Kent Butler picking up the loose ball, going in for the score. After that, Alex Hanks on for a 29-yard field goal. Now, Georgia Southern, again, great field position. It's been theirs all night long. Looking at third and four at the ULM 33-yard line.
So they said we lost a yard on that.
Ball just inside the far side hash. Kevin Ellison, Matt Breida in the backfield. Two receivers right, two to the left side. Now they'll motion a receiver and Miles Campbell. Going to keep it. Ellison coming near side has to crash down at the 30-yard line. Will be shy of the first down by a yard. It will be fourth and one as Justin Backus. Great tackle to keep Ellison from getting one more leap towards that first down stick.
Good defense by the Warhawks.
Eagles on the air 30% on fourth down. Coach Willie Fritz out there making the decision. Looks like the offense will stay out. They'll go for it here. It's Ellison and Breida will work in the offensive backfield. Fourth down and a yard. They need to get to the 29 of ULM. They'll give it to Breida. Can he do it? He's got it. Down to the 27. Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles. Breida making no bones about it. He just wanted to pick up the first down, saw the hole. Dove for it. Picks up 3 yards. It'll be first down and 10, Georgia Southern. Each Eagle first down presented by Franklin Chevrolet. Check them out on Northside Drive or online anytime at franklinchevrolet.com. They'll send out Keaton and Miles Campbell wide to the right side. Ryan Longoria, the wide out to the near side. First down and 10 at the ULM 27-yard line. A motion Keaton right to left. Ellison comes out firing. Long throw across the field. Campbell's got it at the 18-yard line. Spilled out of bounds at the 17, but enough for about a 10-yard reception. Lindsey Pipkins on coverage, but not before the Eagles pick up another, it appears. Franklin first down. They hit it right at the sticks, and Campbell right where he needed to be, and Ellison put it right on the numbers. Had to throw that one. Good long throw by Kevin Ellison across the field very quickly on a frozen rope.
Yeah, and into the wind, too.
Franklin first down. Mark the ball at the 17-yard line of ULM inside the clubhouse red zone. The give to Breida right side. ULM gets out in quickly, but not before he makes it inside the 15, down near the 13-yard line. Pick up a four. It'll be second down and six. As I mentioned, Breida, not known for those short yardage gains. He's known more for 60 yards, 70 yards, and 80 yards plus. But still gets to the hole very quickly. He'll stay in that offensive backfield. as Campbell and Keaton line up as wideouts to the near side, working from the far side hash. Snap put in the belly of Breida. He's loose. 10, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Put an Eagle 6 on it. Touchdown, Georgia Southern. Matt Breida in from 13 yards out. And the Eagles make it 16 to nothing. Again, not something we're used to from Breida, picking up those short yardage touchdowns, but he'll take it there as Willie Fritz, the first out to congratulate the junior out of Brooksville, Florida. And Alex Hanks on for the point after with 12:58 remaining here in the second quarter. Dobson to hold. Here's the snap. Place down. Laces out.
Ooh.
Kick is on its way. Kick is no good. There's a flag down on the ULM side of the line of scrimmage, so we'll wait and see what that's all about. But Alex Hanks, who had been perfect on the year, 8 of 8.
For 76 defense.
Good.
Half the distance.
All right.
We
get to re-kick that ball. That's good. I think Dobson did a very good job of getting the ball down for Hanks. It's good to have somebody like Dobson there as a holder. I know that Nowicki fills in as well. Dobson was a very, very good quarterback in high school.
Rather 16 of 16 up to that point, but the infraction against ULM, their fifth penalty of the night, will allow Hanks to retry, reload here. Trying to make it 17-0 with 12:58 to go in the second quarter. So Dobson again will try it. 19-yard point after here. ULM again looks like they're going to try to come after it here. Dobson gets the indication from Hanks. Low snap. Laces out. Kick is up. And this time the kick is good. So ULM gives him another try, and he stays perfect down the season. 18 of 18 point afters, and the Eagles extend the lead 17 to nothing with 12:58 remaining here in the second quarter. We'll return to Monroe, Louisiana in just a moment. You're listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports. Fans, a dream team at Colonial House of Flowers, handpicked to share their unique talents and dedicated, loyal, and incredibly creative to fulfill the customer's needs. They enthusiastically deliver to Statesboro and the world, always with a kind smile. Colonial House of Flowers, official florist to Georgia Southern Athletics. 17-0 our score. Georgia Southern with their first offensive touchdown of the night. It was Matt Breida from 13 yards out. Alex Hanks missed on the initial point after, but a penalty against ULM in what has been a penalty-ridden first half thus far gave him another shot. Now he's 18 of 18 on the season with point afters.
Nine play drive, 64 yards, used up 3 minutes and 36 seconds. I don't know how many penalties on that drive, only a few between the two teams on the night so far. 13 penalties on the night between the two teams. Eagles go up 17 to nothing on a Matthew Breida 13-yard scamper. Alex Hanks puts the extra point in, 17 to nothing. Domino's Pizza Drive Delivery, presented by Domino's, the world leader in pizza delivery, proud sponsor of Georgia Southern Athletics. Georgia Southern Domino's is open really late. Call them at 912-681-4326 or go to dominoes.com as Young Wei Koo kicks it off this time into the wind. It's going to be short, Chris.
It'll be fielded by Caldwell at about the 14-yard line, trying to find a lane far side, breaks through a couple of tackles, makes his way up to the 34-yard line. So that one hung up in the air. Again, a lot of wind in the face of Young Wei Koo, and Caldwell coming up to make the return, averaging about 20 yards of return on the season. Gets that one up to the 34-yard line. Best starting position for ULM. They started at their 30 and started at the 25 two previous occasions. So now at the 30, just shy of the 35-yard line, Garrett Smith and company. Not a lot to show for so far tonight. Offensively, Smith, single back, blocking back in the backfield. Play action, running to his right, under duress. Now will be dropped, but he will able to pick up a yard. Lunging forward, Jay Ellison, along with Jamal Johnson and Deshante Gallon, had a chance to bring him down in the backfield, couldn't wrap up. Pretty good move by Garrett Smith to get free. Picks up a yard, it'll be second down and 9 at the 36.
Good play call by Jack Curtis for having Ironhead basically spy him. A great job by our defensive backs back there on coverage, so he had no one to throw to.
Another empty set, trips to the left. One single receiver near side. He'll come to the near receiver. Catch made at the 40. Matt Dobson brings down Harley Cieno, but not before he makes it to the 41-yard line.
Good coverage by Dobson. He was on. It was a great pass. But Dobson took him down right away. And that's a play where your receiver, you hope your receiver can break that initial tackle and pick it up. But Dobson was having nothing to do with it.
Third down and three upcoming here for ULM so far on the night. 2 of 5 on third down. Single back to the left side of Smith. Now the two wideouts bunch up. Tight formation here just off the line. Two receivers right, one to the left. Smith, pressure coming, lets this one go. Catch made at the 47-yard line. Near side, out of bounds. He'll pick up the first down, and Jalen Holly hauls it in, his second catch of the night.
Again, threw the ball where only his receiver could catch it. Put it right where he needed to as he was going out of bounds, enough to pick up the first down. First and 10, ball's going to be spotted the 47.
13 rushing yards so far tonight for ULM. 54 total yards of offense. Looking at first down and 10 now at their own 47-yard line. Send trip receivers bunched to the far side. Single receiver down to the right. This time the handoff going to come. A little room off the left side as Kalen Watson makes his way into Eagle territory. Now a big pile. They climb on top of him, and eventually the whistles come after he makes it to the 47-yard line.
Kind of can't get on the players there. You play through the whistle, and there wasn't a whistle. They kept going. I thought Antoine Williams had the tackle there in the initial hit. He was able to break through him. That's why he was able to pick up 6 hard yards. Good run.
Second down and 4. Now at the Eagle 47-yard line. Two receivers wide to the left, one to the near side. Smith in the gun, single back, and Watson to his left side. Here's the snap, give to Watson, running down here right side. Finds a little bit of a hole before the Eagles able to bring him down at about the 43-yard line. Shante Gallen and Bernard Dawson making the tackle for the Eagles.
Well, they're going to get a measurement. Again, we hit him early, and he was able to break a tackle. That's twice. We've seen that tonight. Big J. Allison was the first one to hit him. Usually, if he gets his paws on you, you're not going anywhere.
6 feet, 218 pounds, Kalen Watson, the sophomore.
Doesn't matter. I would.
They'll bring the chains inches from the far side. Inside the near side hash, they'll stretch him out and see where they are. He's going to be shy, just very shy, a couple of inches for picking up the first down.
I got a good view from up here, way up here.
So third and short. So it's new glasses.
I guess that's what it is. I don't know where my old ones are. Somewhere on the path to Duck Commander. Might have been on that railroad track I was walking on and heard shots.
Third and
inches,
ULM. Third and less than a yard.
That's a story for another day.
Needs to get just inside the 43. The ball outside the 43 here on the near side hash. Watson will be on a wing to the left side of Garrett Smith, redshirt freshman quarterback. Two receivers to the right, one wide to the left side. Eagles coming after this, and this time Smith will keep it inside to the left. Make his way down to the 42-yard line. He's got the first down. Matt Dobson makes the tackle.
To be able to get there, Joe tackles, can't do that right now. As soon as we have access to that, we can, but I'd have to say, between Dobson and Ironhead, they'd probably be the leading tacklers here tonight.
First down and 10 at the Eagle 42-yard line. Second time tonight ULM's been on the Eagle side of the field. Now with a fresh set of downs, they'll send two receivers to each side. Devontae McNeil checks in as the running back. Throw, and on the slant, catch made at the 30-yard line. Inside the 30 to the 28, 12-yard strike, and it's a first down for ULM.
Beautiful-looking play. Play action pass. Zipped it right where he needed to. Give him credit. That was a good one.
So first down and 10 now at the 28-yard line. Quick snap. Running far side. Get inside the 20. Demarius Gillespie. Flag is down.
Thinking that this is going to go against ULM. I saw that block almost. You cannot be blocking on a screen. I mean, on that particular play as a receiver. Now, on the way that play is set up, and he came in there, and that flag came in a little late. And I thought maybe they might, they may have missed it. I don't know what the call is here, but that's what I'm hoping for.
Wait on Jeff Hillier to give us a
holding. 83 yep. Offense. 10 yards penalty for the spot of foul. First down.
He came in quickly and got on Darius White and had him. And the back line judge saw it, and I thought Darius was going to be able to make the tackle, and he was just kind of taken out. So good call by those Sun Belt officials. That would be the 14th penalty on the night so far.
Near sideline, ULM not happy with that call, but it will back up the Warhawks after a big pickup. It'll remain a first down.
It's like 15 at the 34.
At the spot of the foul, it'll be first and 16 as they mark it up. Empty backfield, design run for Smith. He's got room, dancing inside the 25, brought down at the 23-yard line by Antonio Glover. Got to the second level and then some. Big hole on that left side allowed Smith to scamper.
And a great block thrown by the referee on Matt Dobson. He was coming to make the tackle. He was in the way.
Second down, 5. Smith again will try to run. This time, brought down quickly at the 24-yard line. Darius Sapp got to him first. Almost the same play, trying to run on that left side inside the B gap. But Georgia Southern stayed at home. Ross Alexander in there for the tackle as well. So burn me once, Georgia Southern says enough. But it'll be an important third down and 5. Now at the Eagle 34-yard line on the day. 4 of 7 on third down for ULM. Critical here, down 17-0. 2 receivers left, 2 to the right side. The right side, the wide side of the field. Empty backfield, pressure comes. Dumping off the screen, catch is made behind the line and dropped immediately. Marcus Green hauls it in. Deshante Gallen cuts him down quickly. Loss on the play, trying to set up the screen. And now an important fourth down and long upcoming. 4th and 8. And it looks like ULM will try to go for the field goal with Craig Ford. Ford on the season is 1 of 1, made 20, a 25-yarder against Nichols State.
11th play of this drive. Ball spotted at the 34-yard line. So a 44-yard field goal attempt.
Just inside the near side hash. High snap. Kick is down. Leg is up. And the kick is good. Just over the crossbar, and ULM gets on the board. 44-yard field goal off the leg of Craig Ford. And it's now 17-3 with 7:07 remaining here in the first half. We'll take a timeout. We'll return to Monroe, Louisiana in just a moment. Our score, Georgia Southern 17, ULM on a 44-yard field goal. Gets 3. We'll return in a moment. This is Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports. We continue on this Saturday night from Louisiana. Let's pause 10 seconds. Station identification. You're listening to Eagle Football here on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports.
Redeem your special offer. Thank you to Raising Cane's for
back with you inside Malone Stadium here in Monroe, Louisiana. Georgia Southern leading 17-3 over the ULM Warhawks, who finally get on the scoreboard with a 44-yard field goal, longest of the season for Craig Ford, the redshirt freshman. Only had 1 field goal previous in the season. That was a 25-yarder against Nichols State. With 7:07 remaining here in the first half, ULM will kick it off left to right, wind at their back. Georgia Southern send back Derek Keaton to field this one off the foot of Craig Ford. Very penalty laden here in the first half. Each team with 7 penalties in the game. Eagles with 55 penalty yards given up, 47 yards given up by the Warhawks. Here's the approach by Ford. Puts a foot into this one. Angling near side, going to be short. Keaton lets it take a bounce, picks it up at the 5. Near side, now cuts to the far side of the field, trying to line up some blockers. Now up the middle, across the 25, and finally stopped just shy of the 30-yard line at the 28. That's where the Eagles take over. First down and 10. Fans Food World has the largest selection of organic and gluten-free items for your tailgate at Paulson Stadium. You visit them on Fair Road or any of their five locations in the Southeast. Food World, the official grocer of Georgia Southern Athletics.
As we talk about the defense, so far 37 tackles on the night for the Eagles, 13 of them solos. And as we mentioned, Ironhead and Dobson are your two leading tacklers for the Eagles so far on the night. Ironhead has 8 total tackles, 3 of them solos.
So really the official third series for the Eagles, and Fabian Upshaw comes in at quarterback, and before he can even get the team lined up, there's a flag dropped by the referee back at the 19-yard line.
Illegal substitution offense, more than 11 players in the formation. 5-yard penalty, first down.
Wow, Coach Willie Fritz has got to be beside himself. That's the 8th penalty of the night so far, with 7 minutes remaining in the second quarter, and so many have been pre- and post-snap. Yeah. So first down, 15, as it backs him up. Again, Upshaw in. Run the offense here at quarterback. Taking the pistol snap, giving to Breida, trying to find room off the right edge. He's free. 30, 35, heads to the far side. Shoestring tackle at the 40. He falls forward to the 44-yard line. Lindsey Pipkins able to save before Matt Breida got out and running. Monte Crockett out there on the lead block, but a good pickup on first down and 15. Eagles pick up the Franklin first down off the run by Matt Breida. Breida with 10 carries so far tonight.
22-yard run by Breida.
Just over 100 yards with that rush. This time Upshaw going to keep Nick near side. Stood up as he makes his way to about the 47-yard line. ULM able to cover him up quickly. Closing quickly, and it was Mitch Lane coming up to make the tackle.
When he picks up 4 yards on it, what a good-looking backfield. I mean, think about that. He had Breida, L.A. Ramsby, and Wesley Fields back there with him.
Fabian Upshaw, 6'1", 170 pounds, out of Titusville, Florida. Now we'll have twin backs. They're back there to block. He'll loft this one into the air. One-on-one coverage and knocked down at the ULM 30-yard line.
Incomplete. There is a flag.
And another flag down on the field. They have tried to take advantage again.
Number 34 defense was in the neutral zone to snap. 5-yard penalty, second down.
Michael Johnson in the neutral zone. But the good news, if you're a Georgia Southern fan trying to take advantage of the neutral zone, this time no interception.
No interception, but it's that play that y'all love so much. And it's another penalty. It's going to bring up second down and 1. That's the second one on Johnson, by the way, tonight. So now it's a second down and 1. Ball at the 46-ish.
Yeah, we'll say the 46-and-a-half of ULM.
You didn't like sixes?
Second down and 1 yard here as Upshaw calls for the pistol snap. He'll run downhill, near side, setting up option. He's free, 40, 35, 30, 25, 20, down the near sideline at the 10. Takes a shot out of bounds and around the 1-yard line for Fabian Upshaw. Justin Backus came in to save the score, but a huge run of 45 yards. For Fabian Upshaw, sets up the Eagles with a Franklin first down. First down, goal to goal at the ULM 1-yard line.
Great option there. Had the pitch man, saw the lane, used his speed, went to the sideline, outran a linebacker, took a defensive back at the end to take him out of the 1-yard line. The Eagles knocking on the door and responding to the 3 points put up by ULM earlier.
L.A. Ramsby checks in as the featured back. Upshaw out of the pistol. Two H-backs to lead block. Here's Ramsby off the left side into the end zone. Put an Eagle 6 on it. Touchdown, Georgia Southern. L.A. Ramsby with his third rushing touchdown of the season. He'll make it 23-3 with 5:29 remaining here in the second quarter. All set up by the 45-yard run by quarterback Fabian Upshaw. Alex Hanks on to try to add one more.
Beautiful, beautiful play. We've had some problems with the snapping tonight. Dobson on a couple of the extra points has done a good job getting it up. Hanks, I think, has done a very good job considering the low snaps and getting them through. Hopefully he'll continue to.
Dobson to hold. Good places snap. It down. Kick on its way. And the kick is good. So Hanks stays perfect. Extends the lead 24-3 with 5:29 remaining here in the first half. Georgia Southern starting to stretch its legs. ULM will get the ball back when we return to Malone Stadium in just a moment. Our score, Georgia Southern 24, ULM 3. This is Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports. Get impressive fuel economy without sacrificing power when you drive the 2015 Ford F-150 or Fusion. Available with EcoBoost technology. Right now, get great lease options or big cashback savings on the full lineup of cars, trucks, and SUVs with EcoBoost at your local Georgia neighborhood Ford dealer, proud supporter of Georgia Southern Athletics. Danny Reed, real quickly, down on the sidelines, not a huge crowd here, but got to be very different for Georgia Southern. Very quiet when they're running up and down the field inside Malone Stadium.
I think it's pretty advantageous for them when it is that quiet. What you do hear from the far left corner is about a group of 200 to 300 Georgia Southern fans who made that long trip from Statesboro. Whenever they get loud, that's when we know things are going good for blue and white.
Trey Caldwell will be back deep for ULM and a nice return last time out. Youngway Koo still going to kick with a wind in his face, right to left on your dial. 24-3, Georgia Southern leading. Matt Breida with a touchdown, L.A. Ramsby with a touchdown, and on special teams, Kent Butler with a touchdown. The opening possession of ULM, Shante Gallen with the block punt, his second of the season. Butler with a scoop and score.
Four plays, Chris, 72 yards, buck 38, set up on a 45-yard run by Fabian Upshaw. L.A. Ramsby punches it in for a touchdown. Your Domino's Pizza Drive delivery. Presented by Domino's, another short kick by Youngway Koo.
This time Caldwell has trouble, now picks it up at about the 16, moves across the 20 before being smothered at the 22-yard line. That time had to come up a little bit. He was standing back around the 7-yard line. Again, just like last time, the kick held up in the air with the wind. And then on his way in, almost at a knee to haul it in. And then bobbled it momentarily, but does secure possession. And it'll be first down and 10 at the 22-yard line of their very own. It's ULM, and they're all gray P45 uniforms. Come out to start this series. Garrett Smith, the redshirt freshman quarterback. Very little success, but a little bit throwing the football. Not much. So hand it off. Kalen Watson stood up as he got just beyond the line of scrimmage, maybe to the 23, a gain of a yard before a wall of defenders come up for Georgia Southern, including Jamal Johnson leading the charge. Put a hat on the ball carrier. It'll be second down and 9 at the 23. Ball placed on the near side hash as ULM attacks left to right on your dial. They'll send trip receivers out to the left. Two receivers to the right. Empty backfield for Smith. Four down linemen. Eagles try to bring the pressure. Here's a quick throw and incomplete at the 27-yard line. Threw it low. Jared Mapps tried to go down to pull it down. Darius White was there on coverage. The Mapps couldn't haul it in quickly just like that. It's third down and 9 here for ULM.
Good coverage by Darius, right on top of the receiver, hits him as soon as the ball gets to him.
Third and 9 for the Warhawks. Trip receivers left, two to the right side, another empty set. Gallen coming up to help a three-man front here defensively. See if they back into pass coverage, and they will. Smith fires this one incomplete, looking for a man around the 35-yard line, but thrown above and behind the intended receiver. It's incomplete, fourth down and 9. Jared Mapps again, the intended receiver for the Warhawks, and without question, that'll bring out Chris Qualls, who may be a little nervous as he'll go back to punt this away. He'll be inside his own 10-yard line last time he came on. Deshante Gallen came in with the block punt. And a scoop and score by Ken Butler.
Wind at his back, though.
And Gallen again lining up at the line. They'll come after it. Qualls will get it away.
Beautiful punt.
Nice punt. Sends back Keaton calling for the fair catch. He'll haul it in at the 31-yard line. That's where Georgia Southern takes over. First down and 10 with 4:38 remaining here in the first half. And the Eagles up 24-3. The Forum at Statesboro, home to luxury student living near Georgia Southern. Amenities include indoor basketball courts, sand volleyball, 24-hour fitness center, and much more. Study, live, work, and play. They have it all at the Forum at Statesboro. Proud to be an official sponsor of Georgia Southern Athletics. Can you imagine a place like that back in our day, Terry, with sand volleyball, basketball courts, and a 24-hour fitness center?
A fitness center? What is that?
Exactly. I think there was one at the hotel.
Really?
What they told me. First down, 10 at the 31. Eagles back to work offensively. Ellison Pitch near side. Got it to Wesley Fields up the near sideline, up across the 40, eventually out of bounds at the 43. Big pickup by the freshman Fields. It's a Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles. 12-yard gain. Trey Hunter forces him wide on the boundary near side.
I love that look. Allison at quarterback. He's got L.A. Rasby, Fields, and Breida back there. You talk about pick your poison.
Ellison will send the receivers out. Heaton and Campbell out wide to the right. Longoria, the receiver, to the near side. L.A. Ramsey in as the featured back. Motion the H-back. Right to left. Ellison to keep. Goes left and cuts back right. Gets to the 45-yard line, just beyond the 45 before being brought down there. A gain of 2.5 yards. Cody Robinson making the tackle for ULM. Clock rolls under 4 minutes remaining, second quarter, 3:51 and counting. 24-3, Eagles lead, really a commanding lead out of the gate after getting the score on special teams. Keaton and Longoria will line up as wideouts to the far side. They'll go to the stack pistol eye here. Ellison takes the snap, throws far side, and incomplete at the 40-yard line. Pass slow to get there. There's a flag down. Looked like, again, ULM jumped in the neutral zone, and if they did, that will be their ninth penalty of the game.
Well, we're trying to win that battle, too. We were leading.
Offside, 92 defense, 5-yard penalty, second down.
The good thing is, again, it was that standard pass. It was actually almost intercepted. It wasn't. You can hear the wind noise. If that tells you how windy it is, the Eagles are going into the wind right now, but the penalty is going to make it second down and 3. Looks like the ball is going to be on their side of the 50.
17 penalties between both teams here in the first half. Second down and 2. Ellison, twin backs, will have Breida and Fields out of the pistol set with two receivers to the far side. Scrimmaging from the near side hash, he'll give it to Breida. Looking for blockers. Breida got one at the 49 of ULM. Now to the 40, far side, makes his way to the 35-yard line before being brought out of bounds. Picks up the Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles. Trey Caldwell eventually able to get hands on Matt Breida. Great job of setting up his blocks, waiting for them to happen. He got a great one right at the 48-yard line of ULM to spring him free.
Good job by our receivers over there, setting up the blocks, staying with them, and not getting a holding call in the process. Wesley Fields is going to stay into the ball game.
15-yard gain for Matt Breida. Breida now racking up the yards as we've seen all season long. Pistol set. Wesley Fields gets the carry right side. Slipped and brought down at the 31-yard line. Michael Johnson was aided by the slip by Fields, who was trying to cut back to his left. Johnson credited with the tackle, but another positive gain on the ground, and ULM really no answer for the running game in any way so far here tonight. 4-yard gain makes it second down and 6. Ball placed at the 33-yard line, rather the 31-yard line of ULM. Now they'll send Fields out in motion, wide out to the right side, empty backfield for Ellison. Fakes, now steps back, throws, and incomplete down at the 14-yard line. They were looking for James Dean, and it almost appears for the second time, including that incompletion during the offsides call, that the wind really affecting the football. Took forever for that ball to get there to James Dean. He had to go down, try to haul it in. It's incomplete. Sets up third down and 6 for the Eagles. And tonight, not many opportunities, but just 2 of 4 on third down, but critical here. Trying to really increase this lead going into the halftime locker room with 2:15 to play in the first half, up 24-3. And the Eagles looking at third down and 6 at the 31-yard line of ULM. Ellison going to throw, far side, one-on-one coverage, diving for it, catch made down around the 9-yard line. What a grab by Keegan Williams. Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles. Found the football first, came back to it. They'll say he was down at the 5. It'll be first down, goal to goal. They'll mark it at the 6-yard line. What a play by Keegan Williams. And that time, Kevin Ellison put some oomph into that pass.
Trey Caldwell, who was on coverage for ULM, did not turn around. He was basically face guarding the receiver. Ellison threw it right to him. Our guy made the play. Their guy didn't. Great pitch.
Inside the clubhouse red zone. First down, goal to goal at the ULM 6-yard line. Wesley Fields in as the running back. Ellison takes the pistol snap, gives to Fields. Running to his left, to the 3, to the 2, diving. And they'll say just short. Oh, down at the one-inch line. The flags come out late after the play.
Yep. Might see an ejection here. I don't know here. There was some Lindsey Pipkins got a little excited and started throwing punches. I don't know if our guy did anything back, but definitely saw that. And if you're going to do that, doing it in front of two officials is probably not a good idea.
So, nonetheless, Fields just shy. Tried to get the football across the goal line. It appears it'll be short inside the ULM one, but there were flags all over the field to the near side. Two hankies on the turf, and now Jeff Hillier will tell us what it's all about.
The result of the play is seconds down short of the goal line. After the play, unsportsmanlike conduct against each team.
Oh.
One defense and 83 offense. This is each player's first unsportsmanlike conduct foul. The penalty's offset.
Well, I guess we did do something to start it, but either way, he's very fortunate to stay in the ball game with that. Can't tell if he was actually throwing punches or slapping. It might have been slapping the hands away that made it look like it was punches.
So ULM will call timeout as they stare down. Second down, goal to go from their own one-yard line. We'll take one with them. Our score, 24-3, Georgia Southern leads. 1:34 remaining first half, and the Eagles knocking on the door. We'll return to Monroe, Louisiana in just a moment. You're listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports. Eagles after the timeout, handed off Wesley Fields, left side, goes into the end zone, put an Eagle six on it, touchdown Georgia Southern. Wesley Fields in for his first score of the night, his third of the season, and that will make it 30-3 with 1:31 remaining here in the second quarter. As ULM again, no answer on the ground defensively against Georgia Southern, closing in on 200 yards here in the first half. Alex Hanks on for the point after, and what was a very sparse crowd to begin with is starting to even thin more as we head to halftime. Alex Hanks on for the point after. The kick is good. Make it 31-3 with 91 seconds remaining here in the first half. And Wesley Fields, good to see the young man, and what a triple threat Georgia Southern has in that offensive backfield. In fact, a quadruple threat with Kevin Ellison and Fabian Upshaw at quarterback. And then you got Matt Breida, L.A. Ramsby, and Wesley Fields. All three of those young men already have rushing touchdowns here tonight. And the Eagles extend the lead 31-3 with 1:31 remaining before halftime.
Eight-play drive, Chris, has started on our own 31-yard line. Great catch down the sideline for the Eagles. Put us in good field position. Option work to Wonders, and as you mentioned, get Fields, Rita, and Ramsby all in the backfield at one time. And that's quite a load for ULM. No answer to this offense so far tonight for the Warhawks. Eight plays, 69 yards, used 3 minutes, 7 seconds on the clock. Touchdown, Georgia Southern. They lead the Warhawks with a 1:31 to go until half, 31-3. The Domino's Drive Delivery, presented by Domino's, the world's leader in pizza delivery, proud sponsor of Georgia Southern Athletics. Georgia Southern Domino's open really late, so give them a call tonight or go to dominoes.com. Handling the kickoff here this time around is going to be a field goal kicker. Alex Hanks, who did a good job early on the season. Young Wei Koo has stepped in. But this time around, Hanks is going to try his at kicking into a very brisk wind.
See if Hanks can put more of a foot into it here. This one, again, going to be high.
No.
Actually, they try the onside.
Yes.
They try the onside kick. And it's at the 50-yard line. The Warhawks cover it up. But it almost seemed to surprise everyone. But Trey Hunter Was Johnny on the spot for the Warhawks, that would have been devastating here as the Eagles really trying to put a crushing blow in late here in the second quarter. So Alex Hanks not trying to go deep, but rather the onside kick attempt. ULM able to cover it up. They'll start first down at 10 right from the midfield stripe, trailing 31-3 as Smith in with an empty backfield on first down and 10. Trip receivers left, two to the right. Looking right. Now will roll to his right. Buying time, and this one's going to be deflected and batted down as he tried to release Antoine Williams. Got his paw up there along with Bernard Dawson. And Garrett Smith right now struggling, the redshirt freshman quarterback. Not a lot of success so far tonight. Credit a very good and tenacious Georgia Southern defense who seems to just be pouring it on play after play. It'll be second down and 10. Smith again looking. Got a man open and hauls it in at the 30, sliding down to the 26-yard line is a Jalen Holly. He's been the bright spot tonight. That's his fifth catch. And a big play sets up a first down inside the 30-yard line of Georgia Southern. Quick snap. Smith with room, running to his left, has lots of room. Now decides to tuck and run, has the football out there. No one can get to him. He's out of bounds at the 21-yard line, far side. But a dangerous run if you're Smith.
Very good run. Took off to the sideline, picked up about 8 yards on the play. They're knocking at the door. The ball spot on the 21, set up with great field position by an onside kick. Hanks did just not get the bounce off the turf that he was hoping for, and it went straight to a Warhawk. Literally hit him in the gut.
So now, second down and 3 at the Eagles' 21-yard line.
Clock to 1:05.
So an adjustment of the clock. They had 101. They want 105. And they'll grant it. Changing the clock to 105. Second down and 3 at the Eagle 21-yard line. Two receivers to his left, two to the right side. Again, an empty backfield for Garrett Smith. ULM trying to get a spark here late in the second quarter. Throws across the middle. Drag route caught. Cut down at the 15-yard line. It was Jared Mapps hauling it in. Tackle made by Riyadh Jones.
Good play call again. Across the middle, right before he got hit, was able to dump it off.
Eagles trying to substitute defensively. ULM ready to go. Picking up the first down, first and 10 at the Eagle 15-yard line. Smith rolling to his right now. Will again tuck and run, coming to the near side to the 5, trying to go to the pylon. Takes a hard hit down around the 2, but bounces up all right. The Eagles, Tay Hicklin and Antonio Glover combining on the hit.
That hurt.
But another first down sets up first down goal to go from the Georgia Southern 2-yard line. With 43 seconds remaining here in the second quarter.
They're moving it closer to the 1 now.
Here's the snap. They'll put it on the ground. Nowhere to go is going to be Devontae McNeil. Maybe got inside the 2, but not much more there. And now timeout taken by ULM with 33 seconds remaining here in the first half. And after a great performance defensively, and ULM really struggling on the offensive side of the football from the very start of this game, credit ULM, they're coming right after Georgia Southern, trying to get some momentum, take some of the wind out of the sails here, headed into the halftime locker room. But I got to believe Danny Reed will have a chance to talk with Coach Willie Fritz as they head to the locker room, and got to be happy with the performance offensively for the most part, leading 31-3, but something tells me he's not going to be pleased with 8 penalties and 60 penalty yards here in the first half. But now, more importantly, if you're Jack Curtis, defensive coordinator, and Coach Willie Fritz, and this Georgia Southern defense, you're trying to keep them out of the end zone here. They've limited to ULM to just 1 field goal so far tonight. There'll be second down goal to goal, this time again marked at the Eagle 2-yard line. Empty backfield for Smith. Now they'll bring the back in. Smith going to keep, and he's going to be dropped at about the 3-yard line. Boy, he was hammered by DeShante Ironhead Gallon. Tried to play on the end around as the slot receiver rolled at the snap. Garrett pulled, and DeShante Ironhead Gallon hits him. They'll say just between the 3-yard line, lost half a yard, and a timeout again taken by ULM with 25 seconds remaining here in the first half.
It's their last timeout, too, for this half. So
26 seconds, I stand corrected.
Yeah, good play came in there. Didn't fool us at all on that particular play. Defense playing stout now. Again, if you're just tuning in a little bit, onside kick gave ULM very good field position at the 50-yard line. The Warhawks making the most of it. Got the ball down to the 1, lost a yard now at the 2.5-yard line with 26 seconds to go until half. Trailing 31-3, looking for something to go in there and maybe keep the 1,000-plus people here.
Devontae McNeil will be the single back. And before they can get lined up, I believe a timeout.
This time by us.
Yeah, Georgia Southern not happy with the alignment. They'll call a timeout. They had plenty in their pocket. They'll burn one here. Again, with 26 seconds remaining here in the first half. Georgia Southern up 31-3, but ULM trying to get a small victory here after recovering the onside kick. And now looking at third down and goal to go from the Georgia Southern 3-yard line.
Wind is still very strong. It's gotten very cool. A lot of football left to be played in this ball game. ULM has shown a very good passing attack. Can score quickly. So second half, you can't let the pressure off.
Coming up at the half, the Southern Halftime Report presented by the Georgia Lottery. Russ Brown will step in. But first, we've got a third down, goal to go from the three. Big full set here. Smith comes out, fires the quick pass at the goal line. It's incomplete. Antoine Williams fell back in coverage. They tried to hit Devontae McNeil out of the backfield, and it's incomplete. It'll be fourth down, goal to go from the three. And now if you're Coach Todd Berry, you've got one field goal to show for here. You're down 31-3 on your home field. It's homecoming 2015. It appears he will go for it. Let's wait and see. Just 3 yards away from trying to get a small victory in an otherwise miserable first half offensively for ULM, and they will keep the offense out there. Fourth down. Goal to go from the 3-yard line. This time the throw, catch is made. Another drag route. This time they're in the end zone, and ULM comes up big. Harley Ciano hauls in the catch, and that'll make it 31-9 on a fourth down reception from Garrett Smith to Ciano. And Ciano picking up his second receiving touchdown of the season. That will be the sixth passing touchdown of the season for Garrett Smith, the redshirt freshman. And on comes Craig Ford to try to make it a 31-10 ball game with 20 seconds remaining here in the second quarter.
Dobson hits him right as he catches the ball, but he's a pretty big tight end. Able to hold on to it.
Here's the snap. Placement down.
Nope.
And no. Yep, it got through. It's good.
Sorry.
That'll make it 31-10 with 20 seconds remaining here in the first half. And Georgia Southern dominating here in the first half. But ULM finding a little bit of life here. Waning moments of this second quarter. Danny Reed down there on the sidelines. You'll get a chance to talk to Willie Fritz. I'm not sure, even with a 31-10 score, I'm envious of that position, because even though you lead big, it's been some sloppy play on both sides of the ball here for Georgia Southern.
Well, the good thing is the Georgia Southern will get the football coming out of the half, but the impression that I was getting from being pretty close to the ULM sideline, if they didn't score there, their morale may have been just done for the final 30 minutes. I think that touchdown, granted we're going to find out how important it was, but I think for that point, that moment right there, that might have saved their game.
Yeah, it's a good call, too, by the way. Good. He was tight end, able to hold on to the ball. I thought we had that extra point block, and that bodes favorable for us in the second half because we had great penetration there. Thought we had it.
One of the things Coach Fritz did talk about, Garrett Smith, the quarterback for ULM, was his quick delivery, and he needed it there on that fourth down play to get the score. So the Eagles will get it back with just 20 seconds remaining here in the first half. Derek Keaton back deep. It'll be Craig Ford to tee it up at the 35-yard line to kick it away. Again, the wind at his back, kicking this one left to right. Here's the approach and the kick. Squibb kick down the middle of the field, picked up at the 25-yard line by an up back up the far side hash with room across the 40. And finally brought down at the 44-yard line. It was Patrick Flo who picked it up on the squib kick. Good job securing the football and getting some positive yards. And with 15 seconds remaining, we may see Georgia Southern come out and take a knee and go to the halftime locker room here on a windy night, but a nice evening compared to what many are suffering through on the East Coast here in Monroe, Louisiana.
Good job by Patrick Flo. He actually got a pretty good field position, but we are going to take a deep. But he secured the ball, so we didn't turn the ball over.
So they'll set it up, take the snap. Ellison takes it, takes a knee, and the final 14 seconds will roll off the clock here at Malone Stadium as Georgia Southern heads to the locker room, leading 31-10 over ULM. We'll go down on the field. Danny Reed will catch up with Eagle head coach Willie Fritz. Danny.
Coach, a penalty-riddled first half on both sides. How have you guys maintained your composure?
Yeah, at this point, we had way too many penalties, way too many unforced penalties, and, you know, other than that, we're playing a pretty good ball game.
All three of your running backs have touchdowns. Defensively, you held them to 10 points. What's been most pleasing about it?
Well, I just think we're doing a pretty good job of rushing the passer and making him get the ball off quick, and for the most part, we stayed over the top defensively.
Coach, thank you. Chris, back to you.
Thank you, Danny. Thank you, Coach. We're at halftime here, homecoming 2015 in Malone Stadium at ULM, and Georgia Southern spoiling the party at this point at the half. Our score at the break, Georgia Southern 31, ULM 10. Coming up next is the Southern Halftime Report presented by the Georgia Lottery. Remember, today could be the day. Russ Brown steps in next, takes you through the first half stats, first half highlights, scores from around the country, and then we'll get set for second half action here in Monroe, Louisiana. Again, our score at the half, Georgia Southern 31, ULM 10. This is Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports.
This has been the Southern Halftime Report. The second half is just around the corner on the Georgia Southern Sports Network. Now, once again, with the call of the game, here's the voice of the Eagles, Chris Blair.
Cold outside here in Monroe, Louisiana. It's been cold for the Warhawks and University of Louisiana at Monroe as well. The Eagles dominant in the first half, 31-10 is your score. Really hasn't been that close. Penalty-ridden first half. Eagles looking to correct that here in the second. High above Malone Stadium here. Second game in the SoCon. Listen to me. I'm having flashbacks here at the crowd because it's reminding me of some of those games. It's a small crowd here tonight here in Monroe, Louisiana for homecoming. The Eagles way out in front. And it's the second contest here in the Sun Belt for your Georgia Southern Eagles. And, Chris, hopefully Coach Fritz had a nice talking to him about the penalties, because really that's the only place in the first half that I can look to that says really the Eagles need to work on that.
Well, you can hear talking to Danny Reed on his way into the halftime locker room, his displeasure with a lot of the pre- and post-snap penalties, and eight penalties in the game, certainly not something you want to look at and be very proud of. But Georgia Southern, again, as Terry mentioned, 31-10 they lead over ULM. Start of the second half coming your way. And the second half kickoff presented by Georgia Farm Bureau and your Georgia Farm Bureau agent since 1959, serving the interest and insurance needs of Georgia residents and Georgia residents only. It'll be Craig Ford kicking this left to right. Back left corner of the end zone, out of bounds, and it'll be, or rather not out of bounds, but out of the back of the end zone. It'll be a touchback, and Georgia Southern starts first down and 10 from their own 25-yard line. It was a small crowd. Terry alluded to it earlier for the start of this game, and then at halftime there was a mass exodus, a line of cars across the way behind the stands to the far side. And unfortunately, ULM will not have a vocal crowd to try to help them get back in this game, and Georgia Southern will try to certainly keep them out of it here on a very cool night in Monroe, Louisiana. 31-10 our score. Georgia Southern with a football, first down at 10. At their own 25-yard line, they'll start out far side hash, attacking right to left in the stack pistol eye. Ellison will keep, setting up option right side, brought down from behind as he makes his way to the 32-yard line. It was Mitch Lane coming in to make the tackle. And in that first half, Georgia Southern, overall, 240 yards of total offense, 141 for ULM. Georgia Southern doing it on the ground. There's a flag down.
There's a shot.
No surprise. We'll see what it's all about from Jeff Hillier.
Watch his, you say chop block?
At least 15 yards, first down.
We haven't, wait a minute, did he forget we don't run that option anymore? There's no chop block, I'm just kidding. Chop block, and that's going to push the Eagles back pretty good here. Not the way you want to start the second half, Chris, as we just talked about penalties, and here we are. It's going to be first down, and it's like 20.
After picking up some yards, the penalty will negate that, but the Eagles, 192 yards on the ground. Matt Breida, 10 carries, 94 yards in that first half. And now backing the Eagles up, first down and 19, with the ball at the 16-yard line of Georgia Southern. Twin backs again, Fields and Breida back there with Kevin Ellison, a receiver to each side, and they'll try the option to the near side. Ellison fakes the pitch and has to eat the football, and he's brought down at about the 18-yard line. Had nowhere to go. Hunter Kissinger, pretty good fit that time for ULM. Taking away the pitch option there from Kevin Ellison. So it will be second down and just a two-yard gain. It'll be second and 17 for Georgia Southern as they move it to the near side hash. As I mentioned, a very windy and cool Saturday here in Monroe. And between the weather and the score, it certainly has sent the Warhawk fans looking for heat and cover here tonight.
Very good defensive play right there by the Warhawks.
Second down, 17. Ellison, ooh, pitch coming deep in the hole as Wesley Fields, or rather Matt Breida, goes right and then comes back left. Ellison lead blocking, gets him free to the 30, 35, and spilled down at the 38-yard line. Big run for Matt Breida, picking up the Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles. Cody Robinson made the tackle, but what a job out there on the corner by Kevin Ellison. Gave the block that Matt Breida needed to pick up six extra yards and pick up that first down.
Took the guy out, too. He went low and tipped him upside down. Exactly. A little improv there by Breida. We've seen him do it before. And a good heads-up by play by the Eagles to stay in the game. What I mean by that are in the play and not have any holding calls and throw the necessary blocks to get the seal so he can make the turn there and pick up the first down. Coming off of a crucial penalty, they had their backs up against the wall a little bit there.
Matt Breida now 11 carries, 114 yards on the ground, including one touchdown from 13 yards out. A little halt in the action. They've yet to start the play clock. Georgia Southern is still waiting to huddle up. Not sure what the delay is all about.
Making sure he's off the field, perhaps.
Finally, they get it clear. Now they'll start the play clock. They'll send out Campbell and Longoria wide to the right side. Derek Keaton, the lone wide out, to the near side. L.A. Ramsby feature back with Kevin Ellison. L.A. gets the carry and bear hugged immediately behind the line of scrimmage. Did get back. Should be no loss on the play, but Michael Johnson came free. The linebacker, leading tackler for ULM, comes in and makes the stop.
He just walked up on the line of scrimmage, that three-man front. He came in as your linebacker, and he just literally came hard off the corner.
Second down and 11 now at the 37-yard line. So got the knee down behind the line of scrimmage. He'll send out Keaton wide to the right, Longoria in the slot to the right side. Twin backs, Ramsby and Wesley Fields. Pistol snap coming to Kevin Ellison. Give it to Ramsby, hole right side, Ramsby loose. Ramsby across midfield and slips on his own footing. Inside the 40, but down to the ULM 37-yard line. Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles. Lindsey Pipkins will get credit for the tackle, but really, L.A. just slipped down the turf down there.
26 yards, good scamper by L.A. there.
So now on the ULM side of the field, first down and 10. They'll mark it at the Warhawk 37-yard line. Ramsby will stay in as the featured back. They'll send two receivers to the near side, Campbell in the slot to the left, along with Williams. Longoria the wide out to the right side. Rather, it's Keaton now in motion. Ellison wanting to throw, pick up the blitz, and pass incomplete, but pass interference, no question about it. They were looking for Miles Campbell, and Lindsey Pipkins came in and dropped him before the ball even got close. And that'll be an automatic first down, and they'll move the football. Pippen. And that will be, believe it or not, the 10th penalty of the night against ULM.
Pippen not happy about it. Thought he had good coverage, but he ended up tripping him at the end. And he was with him step for step. Literally, I just think their feet got caught up a little bit. A little shove at the end with his arms did not help.
So deeper into Warhawk territory. Place the football inside the 25, just shy of the 22-yard line. Georgia Southern, so far tonight, 4-4 inside the red zone. They stay perfect on the season in scores. As they'll break from the huddle. First down at 10. At the 22-yard line, snap back to Ellison. Give off to Ramsby, and Ramsby moves the pile forward down to the 16-yard line. Just made that run on his own. He had three Warhawks on his back. And now there's another flag down. We'll see what this one's all about. It's in the defensive backfield of ULM.
Might go against us. Longoria stayed with his block perhaps a little too long. Maybe a personal foul as he pushed him a little bit. Kind of, I thought, right at the end. But they may be trying to control this ball game. We'll see what the call is.
If it goes against the Eagles, it'll be their 10th penalty of the night.
After the play was over, unsportsmanlike conduct, number 31 offense, 15-yard penalty. Number 31's first unsportsmanlike conduct foul, second down.
That's one of those penalties. I mean, that could have gone either way on that one because it really was right at the end. But that may be a very good judgment call by the official to keep things in check so it doesn't get out of hand with tempers.
So after the infraction, backs the Eagles up, first down. And a cab right here, but still inside Warhawk territory at the 31-yard line. Second down, 19. Snap to Ellison. Give to Ramsby, going right side, tripped up as he makes it to the 25-yard line. Justin Backus able to make the stop for ULM. Georgia Southern so far on the year 100% inside the red zone. Coming into tonight, they were 16 of 16, one of 11 perfect teams in FBS football, and second among those 11 with 10 touchdowns and 6 field goals. They've added to that tonight. And closing in on the clubhouse red zone here, on third down and 13 from the 25-yard line of ULM. Just inside the far side hash with two receivers left, one to the right. Ellison calling for the snap. Rolls back, looking to swing pass. Now will on the draw run to the 20, far side. Stiff arms the defender inside the 15 and maybe just shy of the first down. At the 13-yard line, it was Hunter Kissinger and Trey Hunter combining on the tackle. And Ellison about a yard shy of picking up the first down on a great run. Just faked on the swing to the near side. Took off running. Had a lot of running room and open field to his right. And Ellison will certainly take advantage of that anytime it is offered. It'll be fourth and a little, well, about fourth and a yard. Eagles will keep the offense out there here. In the opening drive of the third quarter, up 31-10. 10:26, clock moving, third quarter action. Ellison with Ramsby. No surprise. Give to L.A. Breaks loose on the right side. Down to the 10-yard line. Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles. They'll set the chains. And depending on this spot, whether or not he's just outside the 10, could be first down goal to goal. Let's wait and see as they try to set the chains. Looks like they'll put it up. Chance to get a first down inside the 1-yard line as Matt Breida will check in. Again, Breida tonight. 11 carries, 114 yards, one rushing touchdown. It'll be first down and 10, just inside the 11-yard line as the Eagles attack inside the clubhouse red zone here against ULM. Give to Breida. Dances right side, tries to get to the 10, stood up there and stopped. After a half-yard gain, it'll be second down and 9 upcoming for Georgia Southern as we roll under 10 minutes, 9 minutes, 39 seconds.
12th play of this drive, Chris, that started on the 25. Penalty pushed us back to the 15. And now here we are with the ball at the 10. L.A. Rams will be checking back into the ball game. Again, 12th play of the drive.
Matt Breida lost his helmet on that play, had to check out, so Rams will be back in the offensive backfield. Second down and 9. Ball placed just outside the 10-yard line of ULM. Eagles can get a first down inside the 1, but they've got their eyes set on a touchdown. As Ellison takes the snap, he'll keep coming near side, throws it with a left hand to Monte Crockett. Not a wise decision there. Luckily, Monte, the only man in the vicinity, has to get it on the short hop, and a great play by Crockett just to go down and smother up the football. Loss on the play of 3. That'll set up third down and 13 upcoming for Georgia Southern. Very uncharacteristic of Ellison. Not trying to pitch with his left hand, threw it back with his right to his left. And a dangerous play, but luckily the Eagles cover it up as Wesley Fields checks onto the field in the offensive backfield. They've got two receivers right, two to the left. Ellison on third and 13. Give to Fields, and he's tripped up at the line, falling forward. May got to the 12, but that's all. And it looks like it'll be up to Alex Hinks to come on and try to add points here. As once they got inside the clubhouse red zone, the drive will stall. Georgia Southern taking their time here, and eventually comes on Thompson and Alex Hanks. So they will try for the field goal here with 8:17 to go in the third quarter in the opening drive of the third.
I'm actually surprised on that particular play that we didn't check out of it. They brought everybody in the box. They all three linebackers came in on a blitz. Hanks going to try a 31-yarder, the near side hash.
Thompson waiting on the snap, places it down, laces out, kick on its way.
Ooh.
And the kick is no good. wide to the right. And Alex Hanks, for the first time this season, misses on the field goal, and ULM holds in the opening drive of the third quarter with 7:51 remaining in the third, and the score remains 31-10, Georgia Southern on top of Louisiana Monroe. And that one is tough. Again, kicking into the wind. Just didn't seem to get a good foot on it, and it just angled to the right.
We talked about the wind and what kind of impact it would have on this ball game, and it certainly had an impact on Alex Hanks' kick right there, as the wind was directly into his face, and it just got away from him. The good thing is, Chris, we get the win in the fourth quarter.
31-10 our score. Timeout on the field. Georgia Southern out in front. ULM will have the ball when we return. You're listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports. Fans, if you're ready to acquire, call Queensboro National Bank and Trust. The Q has 22 branches throughout Georgia. Stop in and you'll say, "The Q works for me." Queensboro National Bank and Trust, equal housing lender, member FDIC. 31-10 our score, 7:51 remaining third quarter. Danny Reed, are you thawed out down there on the sidelines? It's cool up here in the booth. I can only imagine what it's like down on the field.
I can still feel 8 of my 10 fingers.
Very cold night. Unseasonably cold, although here we are, early part of October 2015. Georgia Southern eating up a lot of clock on that last drive, but come away with no points. It'll be first down and 10 at the 20-yard line. Garrett Smith ready to get back to work. Stan Stahl in the pocket, fires this one down the middle of the field, has an open man, caught around the 45-yard line, angling far side. Eagles giving chase, and they bring him down at the 11-yard line. A Jalen Holly. He's the lone returning receiver that the Warhawks can count on, and this time Garrett Smith connects with him. It took Caleb Williams and Antoine Williams to track him down, but a huge pass play sets up ULM inside the Eagle red zone, first down and 10 at the Georgia Southern 11-yard line on a 69-yard pass. Here's the pitch coming near side and hit in the backfield with the football, Kalen Watson. He'll be dropped by Antonio Glover. May got back to the line of scrimmage. Not much there as ULM trying to quickly move up-tempo offense here, trying to catch the Eagles off guard. But the pitch from Smith not fooling anyone, and Georgia Southern staying at home as the tackle made that time quickly by the Eagle defensive squad. It'll be second down at 10 again at the Eagle 11-yard line, this time from the near side hash. Snap back in an empty backfield. This time Smith tosses one up towards the end zone, bobbled. Was it held on to in the end zone? They'll say touchdown, ULM. That time Jared Mapps had it in his hands. It was one-on-one coverage going against Darius White. Hit it in his hands, bobbled it momentarily before hitting the turf. He was able to get under control. And just like that, it's a 31-16 Georgia Southern lead as ULM driving down the field on a 69-yard pass play. And two plays later, they're in for the score. It'll be Craig Ford on to add one more.
Three plays and 80 yards. We talked about their ability to score quickly, and they just showed it. Got behind us there. And a great play by the receiver in the end zone.
Ford waiting on the snap, trying to make it a 31-17 ball game. And now we've got a halt in action.
Probably under review.
They're going to take a look.
Is under further review.
They'll take a look at it here, see if he held on or was aided by the turf. Danny, I'm not sure if you saw it. You had to move quickly after that 69-yard pass, but what do you think on this replay?
I think it's going to stand. I think that ball was bobbled, but he did haul it in before he hit the ground.
Well, at least you got to warm up a little bit.
Yeah, no kidding.
Doing some sprints on that far sideline.
Get the blood pumping a little bit.
So we're under review here.
We have no monitor up here in order to look at it to give you any feedback.
So we'll have to just wait and see. As the replay official
from our 1.7-mile view from up here, looked like he made a very good play. Yeah, and that was a concern for us at halftime, not to come out a little slow here. And offensively, we moved the ball. Hey, Chris, we ate up. What'd I tell you, 7 minutes and 49 seconds on the 14-play drive, just not able to put points on the board.
First time all season the Eagles came up empty in the red zone. ULM taking advantage of it.
It's your fault. You
jinxed
them.
Under replay, David Allman upstairs taking a look at it here. Almost seemed to be one that they could make a decision on very quickly. Of course, depending on the camera angles, which we are not at liberty to. But now, Jeff Hill, you're ready to tell us.
Rooting on the field is confirmed. touchdown.
Is that the first time they've gone to it tonight, by the way, I think, isn't it?
So the touchdown will stand, make it 31-16. Now they'll reset again as Craig Ford will try to add one more. And ULM not going quietly into the night here. Still plenty of time left in this game. Just under 7 minutes remaining third quarter, 6:57 on the clock here at Malone Stadium. Eagles lining up. Kick on its way, and the kick is good. So 31-17. ULM hurriedly goes down the field, tightens the ball game up just slightly. 31-17 our score. Eagles out in front, 6:57 remaining third quarter. We'll return to Malone Stadium in just a moment. You're listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports. Fans, come join the team at Southern Family Dental Group, the official dental sponsor for Georgia Southern Athletics. Dr. Walden and his staff welcome you to their practice. And don't forget, you can catch the Eagles Say Cheese Smile Cam at Paulson Stadium for each home game. Call them for your appointment today. They're sure to give your entire family something to smile about. 31-17, ULM taking advantage of the inability to score inside the red zone. Three plays later, they're down the field. Touchdown pass, second of the night for Garrett Smith, who's now 15 of 24. One interception, has thrown for 166 yards, but had that long of 69 to a Jalen Holly, who's got six catches tonight, 122 yards. Smith has thrown touchdown passes to CNO and that last one to Jared Mapps, trying to get some life here for the Warhawks in a almost quiet Malone Stadium. During the timeout, Hoke Brunson, great Eagle fan, down on the field being honored with one of his longtime friends, honoring their service to the United States Navy. And Hoke getting a nice round of applause. Good to see an Eagle fan here. Many of them made the trip down, but didn't expect to see Georgia Southern's finest being honored on the field here during the timeout. But now, if you're Georgia Southern, Terry, you can't get into slowing down the pace, as ULM has certainly put their line in the sand that they're not going away. Here's the return by Keaton up the near side hash, got to the 20, right up the near side hash, and then cut down at the 24-yard line. But if you're Coach Willie Fritz, very low atmosphere here at Malone Stadium. You lead 31-10 at the half, giving up the touchdown late in the waning moments of the second quarter. You come out, drive down the field, eat up a lot of clock, come away with no points, and ULM right down the field to make this game a little bit tighter. And now if you're Georgia Southern's offense, you have to answer here to reset the tone.
They got the momentum. They scored at the end of the first half, and then they came out here. Georgia Southern stalled, and they scored quickly. So the momentum certainly is on the Warhawks' side right here early in the third quarter. Well, I shouldn't say early, midway through, and it's 31-17, and they're in the game.
First down and 10 at the 24-yard line of the Eagles. Ellison to keep, go right side, fakes the pitch. Ellison with room, 25, 30, 35, 40. And then eventually makes his way up to the 44-yard line. Franklin first down for Georgia Southern. Great decision by Kevin Ellison on the keeper, 21-yard scamper. That gives them great field position, changes the field quite a bit. Now they approach midfield here with 6:38 to go in the third quarter.
I like the sense of urgency from this offense all of a sudden, which is great. I mean, not that they didn't have it the first. They drove down the field, then, as you mentioned, stalled. Ate up a lot of clock, just not able to get points on the board.
Send trip receivers to the left, the wide side of the field. Campbell, Longoria, and Keaton. Now they'll motion Keaton at the snap. Give to Breida, right side. Caught from behind, but moving forward up to the 46-yard line. Got positive yards, about a three-yard gain, maybe just two, as Hunter Kissinger on the tackle at linebacker for ULM. Georgia Southern not huddling here. They'll go ahead and line it up, send Longoria out wide to the right side. Matt Breida, along with Wesley Fields now, in the twin back set. They've got Keaton wide to the left, wide side of the field, as Ellison pauses momentarily, looks to the far sideline, now steps back into the pistol, still with a twin back set. ULM showing that they're coming. Here's the option. Ellison will keep it inside and to the left, makes his way to midfield, stopped just shy of the ULM 49-yard line. It was Trey Caldwell making the tackle for the Warhawks.
Going to bring up third down and four, ball at the 50. Again, the Warhawks looking to stop the Eagles and get the ball back so they can try to strike quickly again. Breida back there with Ellison. The Warhawks have a three-man front, walking up two linebackers, showing a lot of activities, though they're going to blitz the blitz.
Third down and four. Eagles so far tonight, just 3 of 7 on third down, but they need it here. Snap to Ellison. Pitch coming, Breida near side, picking up ahead of steam. Inside ULM territory, inside the 45 to the 43 near side before running out of room. Quick decision by Ellison to make the pitch. ULM was trying to fit it nicely. Breida just beat him with the speed.
They went at the opposite side of the blitz. Do you remember where West Virginia was doing, picking up on some key things of Southern, was able to really time the blitz to the right side. This time we checked out of it and went away from it as L.A. Ramsby checks into the ballgame.
Franklin first down for Georgia Southern, presented by Franklin Toyota. Check them out online, franklintoyota.com. First down and 10. Now at the 42-yard line of ULM, blitz coming. Wow. Sprint pass right side to Keaton, over the head, got his fingers on it, couldn't hold on at the 35-yard line. Time again, the Warhawks bringing the house, plenty of pressure, and Ellison throwing on the run, just had it elevated. Second time tonight we've seen him have to throw early and just a little too high. It's incomplete, sets up second down 10, still at the 42-yard line of ULM.
And he had his receiver open, too, as now Wesley Fields is going to join L.A. in the backfield.
Longoria and Keaton line up wide to the right side, working from the near side hash, attacking right to left on your dial. Ellison gives it to Fields right at the middle on the dive, to the 40-yard line, pickup of 2.5 yards before Jerand Johnson makes the tackle for ULM. Sets up third down and 7 upcoming.
He'd like to have that back. They all took the dive. The option was open. Nobody on the corner.
So the Eagles looking at another pivotal third down here, trying to answer the ULM score in the third quarter. It's 31-17. L.A. Ramsby, the single back, two wides. Check that, trips to the right side. They'll give to Ramsby, running downhill to his left. And for the second time tonight, looked as though he lost his footing, falling forward just to the 37-yard line. It's going to be well shy of the first down. It will be fourth and a little less than 6 here. Actually, about 5. Let's see where they mark it.
Yeah.
Mark the ball at the 37-yard line. Eagles need to get to the 33.
Matt Flynn coming in to punt for Georgia Southern. He's standing on his own 49-yard line. The ball spotted on the Warhawk 38.
Averaging about 43 yards a kick, a chance to pin back the Warhawks. The Eagles yet this season to pin a team inside the 20. Here's the high punt, takes a good bounce for the Warhawks, but a pretty good kick. Be inside the 15, they'll mark it at the 13-yard line, so Georgia Southern gives it back to ULM. Cannot make it happen offensively, and score remains 31-17. Timeout on the field. 3:09 remaining third quarter here from Monroe, Louisiana. We'll take a timeout. We'll return in just a moment. You're listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports. From tailgate to touchdown, show your true blue spirit with Georgia Southern Athletic Apparel from the University Store, the official retail partner of your Georgia Southern Eagles. Shop in-store during the game or go online anytime at gsustore.com. 3:09 remains third quarter, 31-17, Georgia Southern with a lead. Quickly down on the field, Danny Reed, we talked about that big drive offensively, 3 plays in scoring for ULM. It looked like the defense for the Warhawks also took the cue. They looked a lot better on that last possession.
Well, they're starting to bottle up the Eagles a little bit, especially on the inside. Early in the game, they were not surrendering anything on the edge, but now they're starting to take away the middle. The dive may open up that pitch, so that's something the Eagles could shift to in future possessions.
Eagle defense now will have to do battle. Little confidence for this Warhawk offense after that last possession. Garrett Smith, 2 receivers to his left, 1 to his right. Fourth down lineman for the Eagles. Little play action by Smith. Goes right, back to his left. Now gets set, fires this one, and up for grabs. Is it intercepted? Georgia Southern says they have it at the 39. It's an INT taken by Darius Jones. Threw that one into double coverage, and Jones and White were right there on the spot. And Georgia Southern came up with the INT, their second of the game, and that's what the Eagle defense needed in a bad way with 3 minutes remaining here in the third quarter.
That might be reviewed, so I'm waiting to see if that's going to happen. It's hard to tell on the numbers because both of them was there. Darius White was there with Darius Jones, so Hard to figure out which number it was.
Well, for sure, one of the Darius has got the INT.
We'll take it, all right? Good turnover for the Eagles.
Russ Brown, our spotter, always loves it when at least one of the Dariuses gets the INT. Makes his job a little easier. They will not review. Georgia Southern will go to work. First down and 10 at the ULM 40-yard line after the second INT of the game. The give to Breida, trying A-gap right side. Stonewalled as he makes it to the 38-yard line. A gain of maybe a yard, yard and a half. That's about it. Under 3 minutes to play third quarter, 2 minutes and 45 seconds, and the defense certainly answered the bell.
Yes, they did. Big-time interception. A lot of pressure on the quarterback, Garrett Smith. Throws it in coverage. Upshaw's your quarterback. He's got Breida and Fields in the backfield with him.
Third time tonight, Upshaw's been on the field. Had to step in for Kevin Ellison, who was banged up slightly early in that first quarter. Handoff's going to come to Wesley Fields inside the 35. Noses his way down to the 33. Trey Hunter made the tackle.
Eats a lot of clock there for Southern to get that ball back. The Warhawks had scored on their last two possessions. Big time interception there. Huge third down for the Eagles to maintain possession here and try to put some points on the board.
Fabian Upshaw, two carries tonight, 49 yards. Now he'll line up, looking at third down and a manageable four at the 33-yard line of ULM. Two receivers right, one to the left side. Matt Breida in the offensive backfield. Here's the pistol snap. They'll set the speed option. Upshaw will keep. ULM had it covered nicely. They bring him down at the 35-yard line, almost back to the 36, a loss of three. And it'll be fourth down and about 7 yards here for Georgia Southern. Decision time, trying to build some momentum after you had all of it in the first half. ULM takes a little bit of it back on that score to make it 31-17. And it looks like here, Coach Willie Fritz thinking about it, still thinking about it. Upshaw and company stay out there on the field, and it appears Georgia Southern will go for it on 4th and 7 from the 36-yard line. 2 of 2 on 4th down tonight. As we told you, coming into the game, just 30% on the season.
We're trying to draw them off sides again and make it a little more manageable.
Here's the snap to Upshaw. Upshaw in the pocket, fires, and in the belly and incomplete at the 25-yard line. Derek Keaton, I'm not sure his hands touched it. It went right between the numbers, and he couldn't hold on, and it's a turnover on downs. Danny, you may have had a better vantage point. I'm not sure he got his hands on it at all. It literally hit him between the numbers and bounced right off incomplete.
Yeah, that got a lot of forearms instead of hands, and that's unfortunate because he was open, and that would have been a first down.
Very good field position for ULM to take over with 50 seconds to go in this third quarter, trailing 31-17.
So Georgia Southern got a great INT, have nothing to show for it here. Turnover on down, sets up first down and 10 at the 36 of their very own. Garrett Smith back to work, drip receivers to his left, setting up the screen, and it was all covered up.
Oh.
Incomplete. A flag comes in. They were setting up the screen for a Jalen Holly. They're going to play or make it a pass interference call. Boy, it was a lot of traffic to that near side.
They're going
to
say it's a holding cause. He was on his back a little bit, but it was behind the line of scrimmage, and he's fair game to hit, perhaps, and take out, but not hold, if that may be the call.
Well, it may be, because Holly has to come to the near sideline. They adjust his jersey. It was pulled up over his shoulder pad, so we'll just wait and see if Jeff Hillier will let us hear.
Holy, number six, defense. 10-yard penalty.
Yeah, you can take him out, but you can't hold on to him.
So the penalty gives the Warhawks a little better field position here. That's the 11th penalty of the night against Georgia Southern. Almost unheard of in the Willie Fritz era at Georgia Southern. 11 penalties in a game, and we still have 47 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Twin backs flank each side of Smith. He's going to give the right off to McNeil, stretching the field left side. A little bit of room as he turns it north-south into Eagle territory. Bounced out of bounds, down around the 46-yard line. They'll say the 47. Willie Fritz arguing for the 48, and he'll get it just inside the 48 before they're stopped with 27 seconds remaining third quarter.
Caleb Williams going to the sideline with a, looks like his shoulder.
Smith ready to work. Again, twin backs. Play action, rolling to his right. Steps and fires down the near sideline. Overthrown down around the 11-yard line. He had two in the vicinity, but he was looking for Demarius Gillespie, a little overthrown. Stops the clock with 12 seconds remaining third quarter. And we'll set up
second, or rather third down, and five upcoming for ULM.
Gillespie had him by about 3 feet, too. As you mentioned, he had the wind at his back, just sailed on him a little bit. ULM trying to score quickly before the fourth quarter here. Eagles held scoreless in the third.
Third down and four. ULM, 4 of 10 on the evening. Twin receivers, short side of the field to the left, two wide to the right. Here comes pressure. Ball in the air. Matt Dotson pulls it out of the air at the 38-yard line, gets it back, or rather the 43-yard line, gets it back to the 45. Jamal Johnson absolutely comes untouched and puts a hat on Smith as he released. Ball went high into the air. And Matt Dotson able to pull it out of the air for the interception, his first of the season. And back-to-back interceptions for this Georgia Southern defense. Now it's time for the offense to answer the bell with 6 seconds remaining third quarter.
We always talk about Dotson being an athlete. Played quarterback in high school, played safety in high school, recruited as a quarterback here. I guess he could also play basketball because that was definitely a jump ball, and he won.
He out-jumped everybody in a pile of defenders and offensive players. Twin backs, Kevin Ellison back at the reins of the offense. Handoff Fields trying to go A-gap right side. Moves just a little bit beyond the line of scrimmage. They'll say a 2-yard gain. Second down and 8. That'll be the final play of the third quarter. So we move to the fourth and final stanza here in Monroe, Louisiana. Georgia Southern leading 31-17. They led 31-10 at the half. They've been held scoreless so far here in the second half of action. We'll return to Malone Stadium in just a moment. You're listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports.
As Georgia Southern leading here at the start of the fourth quarter, 31-17. Let's get a check of your top 25 scoreboard games in action right now. Number 12, Clemson leading number 6, Notre Dame, 14-3. Number 14, Texas A&M over number 21, Mississippi State, 27-10. Arizona State with an upset brewing out west. They lead 22-10 over number 7, UCLA. Number 9, LSU leading Eastern Michigan 30-22, about 14 and a half minutes to go in that one. And a big surprise down in the swamp is number 25, Florida, leads number 3, Ole Miss, 28-23, 10 minutes to go in that ballgame. Chris?
Thank you, Russ. 31-17 our scores. We start the fourth quarter of action. Fans, remember, Walker Pharmacy, free in-town delivery, online refill options, even text alerts letting you know when your prescription is ready. It's your town, your pharmacy, your choice. Walker Pharmacy, 3 locations to serve you. It's the official pharmacy of Georgia Southern Athletics. Who knew, guys? 31-10, the halftime score, and LSU barely leading over Eastern Michigan. They may have left to go check out the Tiger game tonight.
They may have, as the still in a TV timeout here. Second, they ball the 48. Take the opportunity to send a little birthday wish back home to my youngest daughter, little Princess Gigi, Jillian. A big 12 years old. Thursday night, big party. Big party.
Happy birthday, Gigi.
Yeah, she's big time.
So the Eagles, after the defense is giving them 2 back-to-back interceptions, try to make the Warhawks pay here on first down and 10. Near midfield, Ellison to keep. Again, the Warhawks smother him up. Makes it to about the 47-yard line on the run to the near side. Michael Johnson, Hunter Kissinger, right there where they need to be. And ULM certainly fitting a little bit better here in the second half, Terry, than they did in the first half. Georgia Southern, while some missed opportunities, especially that second drive, or really their first drive of the night, where they covered 31 yards but went back and forth, really was hampered by penalties. But ULM's defense seems to really have stepped it up just a little bit after that last score for ULM.
Great penetration. They're in the lane, not able to make the turn.
Third down and 8 here for the Eagles. They'll motion a receiver in Monte Crockett. Ellison comes out firing, picked off at the 45. This could be trouble down the far sideline. Nobody going to get to him. It's a pick 6. It'll be Junior Williams into the end zone. And the interception puts ULM right back in business. It is now 31-23 on the interception offered up by Kevin Ellison, his second of the season. Williams with his first interception, and it's a pick 6. Things getting very interesting here in Monroe, Louisiana.
I'd say so. He threw that under pressure, called a blitz on him. He had no help right there. He threw it ill-advised, double coverage across the field, and really led the defender pretty nicely. is he able to walk in for a touchdown from 47 yards out. And ULM, the motor, as we mentioned about momentum, is certainly on their side.
Craig Ford with the point after. And the point after is good. It's a 31-23 ball game with a lifetime left here in the fourth quarter. This game was 31-3, eventually 31-10 at halftime, and it's been all ULM offensively here in the second half. And it's 31-24 with 14 minutes to play in the fourth quarter. We'll return to Malone Stadium in just a moment. You're listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports. Georgia Southern football proudly supported by Zaxby's and your neighborhood Zaxby's restaurant. Zaxby's, indescribably good for over 20 years. Well, if you went away, you may want to come back. 31-24 is our score now. It's been all ULM offensively here in the second half, even though the Eagles have picked off the Warhawks twice in the third and fourth quarter, but nothing to show for it offensively. And ULM in front of maybe a few thousand here remaining in Malone Stadium has somehow been able to climb right back into this football game. We've got an emergency crew down in the back of the end zone. It appears a possibly a fan is being attended to by emergency personnel. They've got a stretcher out down just behind the goalpost. But back to action. Craig Ford with a kickoff fielded by Keaton at about the 7-yard line. Goes from near side, far side. Stretches the play 30, 35, far sideline, and tripped up as he makes his way near the 39-yard line. Danny Reed down on the sidelines. I have to believe the Eagle coaching staff beside themselves letting the Warhawks get back in this ball game. I have to believe that during that defensive stand, that offensive coaching staff really in the ear of the Eagles.
Yeah, I had both my ears on, and I could still hear the yells coming out of the huddle. But what happened on the play, when you throw an out route, the Cardinals seeing you cannot miss inside, and we saw exactly why. You get a pick six if you miss inside.
So now first down and 10. Eagles try to regroup offensively. As ULM, not only their offense building momentum, but this defense certainly has changed since that first score in the second half. Here's the give to Breida. Goes left to right on the cross buck and makes his way across the 40. Stopped at the 43-yard line. A pickup of 4 yards. It'll be second down and 6.
Momentum, as we've been talking about, certainly on ULM's side right now, starting with that onside kick in the end of the second half. They took it, put points on the board, and it's been all Warhawk since. Eagles shut out in the third quarter.
Second down, 6 yards for the Eagles. Ellison in the pistol, has Ramsby on the right side. Two receivers left, one to the right. Design draw. Ellison cuts to his left, breaks one tackle, then stonewalled as he makes his way near the 49-yard line, very close to the first down sticks. Waiting to see on the spot, Coach Willie Fritz out there saying, yes, it's a Franklin first down. Let's move the chains. And it will be a first down. Kevin Ellison earned that with his body. Braxton Moore in on the tackle, the backup middle linebacker. As we approach 13 minutes remaining in this game, Georgia Southern cruising, leading 31-10 at the half. ULM, with no crowd support here tonight, has just found a way to get right back in this ballgame. First down and 10, right at midfield. Attacking left to right. Snap to Ellison. Give to Ramsby. Breaking it off right side. Cuts back to his left. Gets to Warhawk territory to about the 48-yard line. Pickup of 3. It'll be second down and 7. And again,
They've got a fan down in the left end zone on the stretcher. They have him braced. It almost appears that maybe he was in the VIP section to the back of the end zone and may have fallen. I'm simply guessing here, but they are taking serious care of a fan here at Malone Stadium. It'll be second down and seven. They've got Breida, Fields, and Ramsby. Ellison going to keep. The Warhawks stay at home, and they bring him down for a loss back at the 50-yard line. They put three backs in. Fields, Ramsby, and Breida, they all break to the left. Ellison trying to counter to the right, and ULM not fooled at all. And a loss of two, and it'll be third down and nine here for Georgia Southern at the ULM 49-yard line. Credit Ben. Defensive end.
You don't want to
Manigou stayed at home and wrapped up Ellison quickly.
Certainly don't want to give this ball back. They've given us every chance to blow them out with the interceptions and us not being able to do anything with it. Here's a huge third down.
Eagles tonight just 4 of 11 on third down. This one may be the biggest of the evening. Ellison with the snap. They bring the blitz. Ellison breaks a tackle, but he'll be caught from behind. Bounce forward. Down near the 40-yard line, may have gotten to the 41. If they give him the spot, it's a Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles. And ULM looks heartbroken because they bounced him 4 yards forward.
And four of their players are on the ground who hit Ellison and bounced off of him. And they're going to get a measurement on this. But one remained on the ground, but four was down at one point. Unbelievable play right there by Ellison. Good effort there, and you have to think that this is we'll go for it anyway, even though we have the wind at our back. I mean, you're talking about an inch here, maybe a couple of inches. It's got to be really close.
So they'll bring the chains from the far side, and ULM looked like he had him hemmed up. Kevin Ellison broke a tackle in the backfield and then moved forward to his left and then was bounced nearly 4 yards as they stretch out the chains. It'll be short by less than 6 inches. And if you're Coach Willie Fritz trying to build some momentum for your team, you're going to go for it on fourth down here in a 31-24 ball game with a ball placed on the Warhawks side of the field just shy of the 41-yard line.
Well, you've been averaging, over 7 yards per play, not in the second half, obviously, but you've been able to run the ball. And they're jacked up. Make no mistake about it. Before the game and during the first half, they had no energy or excitement at all on the ULM sideline. We had all of it. Now with reversals. L.A. Ramsby in at running back.
Last time the Eagles went for it on fourth down, they were turned away. They are 2 of 3 on the evening. This one critical here. Less than a yard. Give to Ramsby. He's got the first down and then some. Breaks free inside the 30. 20, 15, 10, 5. Put an Eagle 6 on it. Touchdown, Georgia Southern. L.A. Ramsby from 41 yards out. And the Eagles get the answer. They dial up the fourth down play. And L.A. Ramsby, the sophomore out of Cincinnati, delivers. And Georgia Southern fans across the country scream, "We love L.A." 10:59 to go. Fourth quarter makes it 37-24. Alex Hanks on for the point after.
Wow.
I think I can breathe now.
No, I can't, actually. But that was a great play. Wow, good run by L.A. Great hole opened up for him on the right side, too. Big extra point.
Alex Hanks with a point after attempt on its way, and it is good. 38-24, 10:59 remaining here in the fourth quarter. And Georgia Southern finally comes alive in the second half, led by L.A. Ramsby on a fourth and short. Rambles 41 yards. We'll return to Malone Stadium in just a moment. You're listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports.
Third Pro of Statesboro, no job is too big, no question too small. Their team of specialists are faster to any size disaster. That's Surf Pro of Statesboro, helping make fire and water damage like it never happened. A proud supporter of Georgia Southern football. Here's the kickoff. Picked up by the Warhawks short. Down around the 9-yard line, coming up the near sideline. Bounced out of bounds near the 25. May have got to the 26 is Trey Caldwell. That's where ULM will take over. 38-24. Eagles with a much-needed score. 41-yard scamper by L.A. Ramsby on fourth and less than a yard. Big hole opened up. Ramsby does the rest. We've talked about what he does, Terry, between the tackles and how he gets those hard yards. We've always known once he gets out into space, he can make a defense pay. He showed it that last time out.
He's got the speed. There's no doubt about that.
Garrett Smith empties the backfield. Motion a running back at the snap. He'll keep, and Smith crushed as he gets to about the 22-yard line. It was DeShonte Gallen along with Bernard Dawson bringing the wood, and Garrett Smith will not soon forget that hit.
No, he won't. That was beautiful right there. Golly, Moses.
Clock moving, 10:35 and counting here in the fourth quarter. Second down, no gain on the play. It'll be second. Well, they'll give him a yard. Second and nine at the 22-yard line. Again, empty the backfield. Send trip receivers wide to the right, two to the left side. Smith, three steps, fires near side. Catch grabbed out of the air up at the 26-yard line. Great catch by Jared Mapps. Mapps hauling in his third catch of the night.
Yeah, very good pass and good catch. Again, Riyadh Jones on coverage, but he threw it where only his receiver could make the play, and he made the play. Third down and about six for ULM here with the ball spotted at the 26.
ULM, their problem tonight, unable to really establish any running game. No surprise, but they're having to move the ball and move the chains through the air.
Pretty effective at it, though.
Here's a third down and six. Smith with a single back. Now they'll motion the big receiver. Smith took his eye off the snap. It's loose down inside the five, and diving on it is Kalen Watson down around the four-yard line. Big mistake by ULM, and they will look at fourth and forever and have to punt it out of the back of their own end zone. Big miscue by the redshirt freshman Garrett Smith, the QB.
They're going to spot the ball on between the 4 and the 5-yard line. You're putting your punter standing about 9 yards deep. He's going to be punting into the wind here, folks. And we've talked about the wind being a factor. It is a straight line in the punter's face at this point. So Southern ought to get very good field position here.
So back deep in the back of the end zone, Chris Qualls had one blocked earlier in the first possession of the game. He'll be two steps away from the back of the end zone. Here it comes. He'll get the kick away.
Actually, a pretty good punt considering.
High into the air and in the wind. Fair catch called for at the 37-yard line by Derek Keaton. So great field position after the mistake on the bad snap out of the shotgun for ULM. And Georgia Southern will have it in fine position with 8:53 to go in the ball game, leading 38-24. And after that mistake, if you're Georgia Southern's offense, Terry, this is where Coach Willie Fritz talks about getting your hands around the neck and putting the opponent out of it. Here's your opportunity.
Put your foot on the neck, foot on the pedal, punch it in. And has not been a very pretty second half for the Eagles. Again, give credit to ULM and their defense here, but Ellison's got to figure out a way to punch it in, extend this lead.
First down and 10 at the 37-yard line of the Warhawks. Motion, Longoria, right to left, give to Breida. Breaks it to the outside, looking for blockers, has a few, 30, inside the 29, down to the 28-yard line, right at the first down, sticks, depending on the spot, maybe about a half yard shy, but a great run by Matt Breida. Longoria doing a great job out there, lead blocking, had a head of steam as he went in motion right to left.
Breida closing in on 150 yards on the night, picked up, 9 yards on that carry, so that should put him at 148.
Second down, about a yard here. Again, the ball placed at the 28-yard line. Kevin Ellison talking to the crew in the huddle.
Let that clock tick as they're getting every...
I'll have Matt Breida right behind Ellison in the pistol. Here's the snap. Give to Breida. Left side. Inside the 25. Stood up and stonewalled at the 24. But he'll have the Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles. As the clock rolls to 8 minutes and 10 seconds remaining here in the fourth quarter of action. 11 penalties tonight. 100 penalty yards against Georgia Southern. In the Fritz era, that's the most. And I'm sure Coach Willie Fritz and company will address that regardless of the outcome of the game. But had 7 penalties 3 times last year.
against Appalachian State, Texas State, and Navy. And so far this season, the most they had was 5 penalties for 40 yards against the Citadel in week number 3. First down and 10 at the 24-yard line of ULM. Georgia Southern trying to keep the pressure on the Warhawks here. Snap to Ellison. Ellison to keep, goes left side to the 20. Had one block, now inside the 15, and really punishes a defensive back down around the 11-yard line. He took Mitch Lane out.
Wow.
They came and met, and Mitch Lane took the brunt of that blow.
Coach Spear, your conditioning and weightlifting program, it's working.
Moves to the far side hash at the 11-yard line. Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles. They can pick up another one at the 1. And with a 7 minutes, 10 seconds remaining, clock moving up 38-24. Eagles inside the clubhouse red zone once again. Been held scoreless just once this season. Came early in the third quarter inside the clubhouse red zone. They'll try to answer for it here. Ellison gives it to Ramsby, left side. He'll lunge forward down around the 6-yard line. Pick up a 5. It'll be second down and 5 for Georgia Southern. Multiple substitutions coming in for ULM. They'll try to bulk up defensively here for a goal line stand as James Dean will check in at H-back. L.A. Ramsby coming out. It'll be Matt Breida in the offensive backfield.
6:41 and counting left to go in this ball game. Eagles like to put some more points on the board as they're leading 38-24 up until this last change of momentum. It's been all ULM since the onside kick in the back half of the second half quarter.
Matt Breida, 18 carries, 143 yards tonight on the Vaden-Nissan stat line. He has one rushing touchdown. Wesley Fields with a rushing touchdown. L.A. Ramsby has 2 tonight. Ramsby, 13 carries, 98 yards. Second down and 5 at the 6-yard line. Give to Breida. Going left to right. He's got room. 5-4-3-2-1. Right corner of the end zone. Put an Eagle 6 on it. Touchdown, Georgia Southern. Matt Breida with his second rushing touchdown of the night. That's his 10th on the season. And the Eagles make it 44-24 with 6:04 remaining here in the fourth quarter.
Once you saw that corner, you knew that they weren't going to touch him. And they literally, I mean, in flag football, he still scores.
Alex Hanks on for the point after as this Eagle offense has woken up. On these last two drives, after being dormant in the early part of the second half, Alex Hanks puts a foot on it, puts it through the uprights. It's good, and it's now 45-24 with 6:04 remaining in the ball game. Timeout on the field. We'll return to Malone Stadium in just a moment. Georgia Southern leading 45-24 over ULM. This is Eagle football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports. From renowned guest speakers to nationally televised football games to the arts, there's something for everyone at Georgia Southern. Stay connected by following the university on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, and others. For a full list of Georgia Southern social media sites, visit georgiasouthern.edu/social. 45-24 our score here in the fourth quarter. 6:04 remains in this game. Second Sun Belt Conference game of the year for Georgia Southern. Got a little tight there as ULM came to life in the second half, but Georgia Southern back-to-back scores, trying to get some room and get some distance on the scoreboard here as they'll kick it back. Still 6:04 remaining. Time now for you to be involved in our broadcast. Pick our Georgia Power player of the game. Matt Breida tonight, 19 carries, 149 yards, 2 touchdowns. If Matt Breida's your Georgia Power player of the game, text GS1 to 90561. L.A. Ramsby tonight, 13 carries, 98 yards. He also has 2 touchdowns. For L.A. Ramsby, text GS2 to 90561. And Matt Dobson leading the way defensively tonight. Text GS3 to 90561 for Matt Dobson. We'll name our Georgia Power player of the game that you vote on coming up in the forward locker room wrap-up. Here's the ensuing kickoff. Youngway Koo puts this one high into the air in the back of the end zone. It'll be a touchback, first down at 10 at the 25-yard line.
Chris, I thought Dobson was a little banged up and might be gimpy tonight. If this is gimpy, I hope he's always a little gimpy.
Dobson with that interception. Eagles had 2 interceptions here in the second half. Unable to make points there, but eventually winning the field position battle after a terrible breakdown. Warhawks with a bad snap out of the shotgun. Had to punt out of the back of their end zone. Great field position, and eventually Matt Breida able to get in from 6 yards out. Now ULM, time not on their side as Smith takes the shotgun snap. But it's in the belly, carrying it right side is Watson across the 25, up near the 27-yard line. Gain of two. It'll be second down and eight. The Eagles covered that up quickly. Antoine Williams, who has been all over the field tonight.
Good linebacker play tonight. Really good linebacker play.
On second down, Smith in the pocket stands tall, delivers the pass far side. Catch made at the 39-yard line to Holly. Out of bounds up near the 43-yard line. First down for ULM.
Good job by Holly, straight to the sideline to get out of bounds and stop the clock. ULM is not going to go away quietly, so don't think they will.
They'll move quickly, empty the backfield, quick snap. Smith steps up, fires this one, overthrown into double coverage. Down around the 38-yard line. The time he was looking for Gillespie. Eagles had him covered up. Tay Hicklin was initially in on coverage, and Smith just throws it away and overthrown. Stops the clock with 5:24 to go in this game. It'll be second down and 10, again from the ULM 44-yard line. Quick snap. Smith, three steps, fires this one into the flat far side, looking for Holly, and that one off the mark, nowhere close and incomplete. Matt Dobson was in the vicinity, breathing down the neck far side of a Jalen Holly, who's been the leading receiver tonight for ULM. Seven catches, 138 yards. Garrett Smith, 17 of 31, has three interceptions, has thrown for 185 yards and two touchdowns.
Dawson helped with that play as he came in and pressured the quarterback. He had no choice but to get rid of it.
Third down and 10 at the 44-yard line of ULM. Single back set on a box car to the left side for Smith. Three steps, now steps up in the pocket, fires across the middle, grabbed out of the air at the 40-yard line, inside the 35. Inside the 30 is Holly. Pick up the first down, big pass and catch there at the 28-yard line. ULM
wide
open to life again.
Good route by Holly, a very impressive wide receiver. Shows his speed and runs good routes.
Smith looking to go to the end zone, launches this one incomplete. Looking to go deep, down around the 10-yard line. Breaking to the end zone was Holly that time, but Smith really had to unload that one quickly and off the mark.
Dobson was right there on top of him, and Glover was on the backside.
Second down, 10, at the 28-yard line of Georgia Southern. Two receivers right, trips to the left side, empty backfield for Smith. Takes the snap, sets up the screen, catch made at the 29, but brought down immediately. Riyadh Jones right there, sniffs it out. Jared Mapps goes down as soon as he holds on to the football. Loss of nearly 2 yards. And it'll be second down 12 upcoming for ULM.
No fooling us there. Riyadh Jones all over him. In fact, Riyadh, if he hadn't been paid attention, probably could have turned and picked it off and picked six.
Riyadh will go out as the DB, far side. They'll man up at the line.
Good play by Jones.
On third down and 12. Smith from the far side hash. Eagles trying to show they're coming after it here. They'll back up as Smith takes a second before taking the snap. Low snap, but handled. Smith fires, and the slant caught down at the 21-yard line. Once again, Jared Mapps. It's been Mapps and Holly tonight combining for 13, I should say, receptions.
Riyadh Jones all over him, though, but a flag's going to be called against Georgia Southern, and Coach Fritz not happy at all on Bernard Dawson. Bernard Dawson showed his frustration with the wrong person.
Unsportsmanlike conduct, number 56 defense. Penalties half the distance to the goal. Automatic first down.
With that guy.
Number 56 is first unsportsmanlike conduct foul.
The guy in the white hat, him? Yeah, that's who he showed his frustration with. He thought he should have been held and turned around and voiced his displeasure. Or should have got a holding penalty, I should say.
12th penalty of the night. Over 100 penalty yards. Half the distance, moves the football down to the Georgia Southern 10-yard line. So the Warhawks, again, not going quietly into the night. Down 45-24 with an even 4 minutes to go. Clock moving fourth quarter. Smith out of the shotgun, takes the snap. Looking left, pressure from the backside, unloads. Catch made at the goal line, and it's a score. What a grab out of the air by Gillespie. Thrown where it had to be by Smith, and he had pressure breathing down his neck. And with 4 minutes to play, it is now 45-30 with a point after upcoming.
Wow. I mean, and he had all kind of pressure on him. He was nailed when he got rid of it. Garrett Smith showed some poise right there, delivered a good pass, great catch.
Craig Ford
trying to add one more. Kick is on its way, and the kick is good. 45-31. 4 minutes even remaining here in the fourth quarter. Get ready for just about anything when ULM lines it up to kick it back to the Eagles. We'll take a timeout return to Monroe, Louisiana in just a moment. You're listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports. Fans, we all know you love the Eagles, so we can ask you to consider buying or renewing an Eagle wildlife plate. Just $25 more helps provide vital support for conserving rare wildlife across the state of Georgia. For more details, go to georgiawildlife.com. 45-31, our score here at Malone Stadium. Eagles led 31-10 at the half. ULM came out firing early in the third quarter, made the game tight. Georgia Southern able to take an upper hand once again late in the third, early in the fourth. But for the second time tonight, a little drama here at the top of the boot state on this Saturday night with 4 minutes to play. It's 45-31. We'll see if ULM tries to gamble here. As I mentioned, time not on their side, but they quickly drove down the field, Terry, aided by a costly personal foul after the play by Georgia Southern, set them up at the 10-yard line. Great throw by Smith.
Nine plays of 75 yards for him. They got the ball on the 25-yard line, Chris. Marched down the field, as you mentioned, a costly penalty. Put him really at the goal line there, and a good pass and catch. Give credit to the quarterback and the receivers for ULM. They are making the catches. Now we're expecting an onside kick here with 4 minutes to go, leading 45-31.
Craig Ford will have the honors. Georgia Southern puts in the good hands team here. Ford tees it up at the 35-yard line. The Gunners all scrambling to the near side. Here's the onside kick going far side. Matt Dobson got his hands on it and I believe able to secure it at the 45-yard line of ULM. It will be Georgia Southern football, and it is Matt Dobson getting his hands on it. And Coach Willie Fritz, the first out there to give him a high five.
Of course, Dobson. Of course, Dobson. Where is it, Dobson? He's everywhere. But Coach Fritz, get out of here tonight with somehow pull off this victory. A lot of things to look at, penalties, and the fact that we gave up 31 points to ULM is not going to make him very pleased.
Danny Reed, real quickly, 45 points you've scored, but I have to believe it's a frustrated sideline down there, especially based on 12 penalties and 109 penalty yards.
It's a little bit of relief after Dobson just recovered the onside kick. Certainly happy to be up by two touchdowns, but you got to wonder if you're Georgia Southern, do you need one more score with the way ULM has moved the ball with that passing attack lately?
First down and 10 at the 45 of ULM. They'll give it to Wesley Fields, tripped up as he makes his way to about the 42-yard line. Stop there. And ULM, I believe, let's wait and see. It appeared maybe they called for time. Nope, clock still moving. So ULM allowing the clock to move after Wesley Fields picks up 3 yards. It'll be second down, a short eight, a long seven here for the Eagle offense, who is in no hurry. Happy to let the clock roll inside 3.5 minutes. Still 15 seconds remain on the play clock. They've yet to break from the huddle. Kevin Ellison now will break the huddle with 10 seconds. They'll line up quickly. Second down and 7. Waiting on the snap. Ellison puts it in the belly of Fields. Running left side. Puts his head down inside the 35. Makes it to the 34. It appears, unless it's a short spot, he will have enough for the Franklin first down. For the Eagles, Mitch Lane making the tackle.
Did we mention that Wesley Fields is a freshman? Just because he doesn't seem to play that way. And he is. 5'10", 185 freshman out of America Sumter High School.
Eagles tonight, over 400 yards rushing offense. Closing in on about 430 after that run by Wesley Fields. It'll be first down at 10 at the 34 of ULM. Again, the Eagles taking their time. 2 minutes, 43 seconds. It appears that Coach Todd Berry not interested in trying to preserve the clock here. Down by two touchdowns. High snap. Ellison able to get his hands on it. Give it off to Fields. Breaks a tackle with the ankles at the 30 and dives his way down near the 26. About 2 yards shy of a first down. Big pickup by Wesley Fields. You're not going to be able to bring him down with that type of tackle, as now ULM will burn the timeout with 2:26 remaining
here in the fourth quarter, down 45-31. 429 yards of rushing offense tonight for Georgia Southern. Only 44 for Louisiana Monroe. They've done their work, no surprise, through the air. Garrett Smith, 21 of 36, three interceptions, but he's thrown for 232 yards and three touchdowns. Jalen Holly with eight catches, 166 yards. For Georgia Southern, Matt Breida, 19 carries, 149 yards. L.A. Ramsby, 13 carries, 98 yards. Both Ramsby and Breida with two rushing touchdowns tonight. Kevin Ellison, 13 carries for 74 yards. Wesley Fields, who we just talked about, 12 carries, 66 yards. Freshman also adding to his touchdown total tonight. So Georgia Southern, a lot of things they'll take a look at. And again, we talked about what a dangerous spot, Terry, this was in the schedule. Back-to-back road trips, the first to Idaho, got the win 44-20. Came back on a late plane, got ready this week, left on Friday afternoon, coming to Monroe, Louisiana, actually flying into Shreveport, about an hour plus away from Monroe, Louisiana. You're happy to come away with a win. You get an off week next week. Maybe everybody out there for the Eagles not playing at 100%. We talk about the injury to Matt Dobson. Chris De La Rosa, who's played stellar in his sophomore season at linebacker, not up to 100% as well. Still some offensive linemen nursing some injuries. And what a great welcome the off week will be for Coach Willie Fritz and company, who I imagine breaking down this film, talking about the pre- and post-snap penalties against Georgia Southern tonight. Very uncharacteristic, but 12 penalties, 109 penalty yards, almost unheard of. In fact, it is unheard of under Coach Willie Fritz here at Georgia Southern.
Yeah, the off week, as you mentioned, couldn't come at a better time. And tale of two halves a little bit, tale of two ball games here. If you look at our two schemes, they like to throw the ball. We like to run the ball. We stopped ourselves. They did a good defensive scheme on a couple of occasions, but for the most part, we stopped ourselves. And I think the coaches in the end may not verbalize it, but this should have been a runaway for them in their mind. And instead, we've allowed ULM to score 31 points. Quarterback, I think, for them has done a pretty good job tonight throwing the ball. You've seen some very good passes from him and those receivers. But again, they really haven't had an answer, you know, as much as they should have for our offense.
Second down and two for the Eagles at the 27-yard line. A give right side to Fields. Almost free. Shoestring tackle pulls him down at about the 15-yard line. Lost his towel on the way through, but Wesley Fields showing his explosive ability to find the hole and get to open field. That is a shoestring tackle away from another score. Junior Williams able to save it for the ULM defense.
And if he would have made that last cut to the right where he had the block, it would have been a touchdown for him. But again, this freshman certainly not playing like one. And here you are at the end of the game where you need to score to keep the ball away from him, and you're giving it to the freshman.
Wesley Fields with the Franklin first down, presented by Franklin Toyota. Proud vehicle supporter of Georgia Southern Sports Network. Check him out at franklintoyota.com. First down and 10 at the 12-yard line. Give to Wesley. Goes right back to his left and runs into a wall down around the 10-yard line. Still moves the pile. Let's see if they may give him forward progress inside the 10 to about the 8-yard line. And he got it all on his own, carrying Warhawks forward. Strong, strong legs and upper body for Wesley Fields at 5'10", 185 pounds. He used all of that and then some.
I was about to pull, what's that guy, Corso, and not so fast. I mean, he kept going. I thought he was really going to squirt out of there and end up scoring a touchdown.
Second down and four. We approach 1 minute remaining here. 1:06, clock moving in the fourth quarter. Coming up, the Ford locker room wrap-up.
Four-minute drive. Not bad.
Second down and four at the ULM 7-yard line. ULM trying to save some pride. They give it to Fields. Cuts to his right, back to his left, hit from behind. Spilled down at the 4-yard line. Still shy of the first down by a couple of yards with 44 seconds and counting. Georgia Southern looking at third and about a yard for a first down. And they'll be 4 yards away from another touchdown here. Clock is stopped with 43 seconds.
ULM actually called a timeout. ULM called the timeout with 43 seconds to go. With us with the ball at the four, putting substitutes in, and they call a timeout to stop the clock. I hope we go ahead and punch it in.
45-31 the score. Georgia Southern 1 yard shy of 500 of total offense tonight. 451 on the ground. More than likely, that will move the Eagles up in FBS statistics when it comes to rushing the football. And that's the kind of insane thing about tonight's game. You see this game 45-31 at some point there in the third quarter, early fourth quarter. The game still in doubt. ULM comes back with reckless abandon, but yet they've been unable to stop the running game all night long. But credit the redshirt freshman, Garrett Smith, 232 yards passing.
You know what, Chris? I got to give Lewis Braxton, one of our Eagles, some credit. They called, ULM called timeout so we could get 500 yards rushing. That was his rationale.
Third down and one. 43 seconds remain. Kevin Ellison, Wesley Fields will line up in the backfield. Keaton out wide to the left. Williams wide to the right side. James Dean in as the blocking H-back. Here's the snap. Give to Fields. Trying to find something left. Cuts back to his right. May have picked up the first down. Maybe just shy, depending on this spot. The far side judge gives him a short spot here.
Wow.
And we've got time. And ULM calls another timeout. That will put the Eagles, depending on the spot. Looked like he got the yard. He was deep in the hole when he got the handoff. But it'll be fourth and short at the four-yard line.
That really didn't look like a good spot. Danny, did you have a good view of that?
I thought he had the first down, but
yeah,
that's still 500 total yards. That's not bad.
So they say no gain.
Wow. Well,
on the play, holds the Eagles up at 499 yards.
Danny. And they call timeout.
Danny and I were in agreement. It looked like he got at least 1 yard, maybe even two. But as it stands, the Eagles were stuck at 499 yards rushing.
Is that not reviewable?
It'll be fourth down and a yard here with 34 seconds remaining. Eagles will try to get a first down, seal the game. If ULM relents, it could be another touchdown here.
All right, guys, punch this one in. We need it.
Eagles come away from the far sideline. Fourth down and a yard. Eagles 3 of 4 on fourth down tonight. Again, just 34 seconds remain. Ellison calling for the snap. Gives it to Fields. Fields goes to the near side, untouched into the end zone. They've got over 500 yards rushing, and Wesley Fields picks up his second rushing touchdown of the night. Put an Eagle 6 on it. Touchdown, Georgia Southern. It's 51-31 with 31 seconds remaining in the ball game.
Yeah, good use of those timeouts. Good job, Wesley Fields. Put an Eagle 6 on that one. It's what we needed. Get over 50 points on this ball game.
503 yards of total offense. 455 on the ground. Alex hangs on for the point after with 31 seconds. Trying to make it 52-31. Here's the kick. It's on its way. And the kick is no good. Wide right. Misses his first on the season. And the score remains 51-31 with 31 seconds remaining. The kickoff ensuing. And Georgia Southern, not the prettiest of games tonight. If you've been watching or listening, you'll be the first to tell anyone who asks you it's not a beautiful night for Georgia Southern. The score lopsided late in the fourth quarter, 51-31. When you go back to the 12 penalties, I should say, 109 yards in penalties tonight. Kevin Ellison, 3 of 9 passing, had the interception. Threw for 48 yards tonight, but it was just an onslaught of rushing. Out of the top four rushers for the Eagles, Matt Breida leading the way, 19 carries, 149 yards, 2 touchdowns. L.A. Ramsby, 13 carries, 98 yards, 2 touchdowns. Wesley Fields, 17 carries, 92 yards, 2 touchdowns. And Kevin Ellison, a quarterback, 13 carries, 74 yards. Time of possession dominated by Georgia Southern, 37 minutes, 50 seconds to 21-39 for ULM. But third down efficiency, not impressive tonight for the Eagles, just 4 of 13. ULM not that much better, 5 of 14. The Eagles deciding to go for it on fourth down 5 times tonight. They were stopped on one occasion. ULM 1 of 2 on fourth downs. But the Eagles happy to pick up their second conference win, albeit not in beautiful fashion here on the road. But they'll head into the off week before coming back 2 weeks from tonight at Paulson Stadium against New Mexico State. Here's the kick by Youngway Koo. Sails deep in the back of the end zone. It's a touchback. First down and 10 at the 25. That's where ULM will take over with just 31 seconds remaining. And, Terry, we were watching the scoreboard presented by Spring Hill Suites. And at last check, New Mexico State surprising a few people. They've struggled all season and actually had a lead, I believe, over in-state rival New Mexico earlier in the night.
They did. And, like I said, caught us all. I say off. It's a little bit off guard as we were looking at some of the other scores. We decided let's take a look at the Sun Belt and see what's going on there. Arkansas State beating Idaho 49-28. New Mexico State leading in the third, 29-22 over New Mexico. Louisiana Lafayette loses to Louisiana Tech 43-14.
Louisiana Monroe on first down decides to keep it on the ground. Ben Luckett in at running back, his first action of the night out of Palestine, Texas. The redshirt freshman, 5'11", 214 pounds, had 19 carries coming into the game, 97 yards. And that'll be the final play of the ball game as both teams start to meet. Final 10 seconds will roll off, and Georgia Southern gets out of Louisiana with a win, 51-31, as the horn sounds, and this one is in the books. Eagles move to 2-0 in conference play. They move to 4-1 overall. For Louisiana Monroe, they'll fall to 1-3, 0-1 in Sunbelt Conference play. And the Eagles happy to get out of the boot state with the win and head into the off week and regroup for the stretch down the season. 51-31, the final score here from Malone Stadium on a cool Saturday night in Monroe, Louisiana. Stay with us. More to come. And later, the Ford Locker Room wrap-up. Terry Harbin, Russ Brown, Danny Reed, they'll all have the first half, second half highlights and stats, interviews with head coach Willie Fritz, and we'll pick our Georgia Power player of the game. We'll continue with more from Malone Stadium in just a moment, where our final score tonight, Georgia Southern with the win, 51-31 over Louisiana Monroe. And for the first time in this series, the road team wins the game as Georgia Southern now goes 4-2 all-time against the Warhawks of ULM. We'll return in a moment. You're listening to Eagle Football on the Georgia Southern Sports Network from Learfield Sports.